Welcome back to a beautiful night in Tampa, Florida. Temperatures in the high 70s, a breeze flowing throughout this beautiful stadium. That may have an effect on the kicking game tonight. And the South Florida Bulls take on the number one team in Division I AA. The South Florida Bulls 2-2 on the season. Jim Leavitt's team with victories over Jacksonville State and James Madison. They take on the number one team in Division I AA. The Troy State Trojans. And there's the head coach at Troy State, Larry Blakeney. Boy, what a job he has done at Troy State. He's in his 10th year. 85-27-1, 75% of his games he has won, and in fact, he is number four on the active coaching list in Division I AA. In fact, in his 7 years in Division I AA, Troy State has gone to the playoffs.
Well, he really has, Al. You know, he's a former Auburn assistant for many, many years, and this looks like a kind of an Auburn team. There's six transfers from Auburn on Troy State's team, and they have 11 transfers from Division I schools, so that's been a big part of his roster.
Bill Gramatica will kick off. Let's remember these two teams played a year ago up at Troy, and Troy State rallied from a 21-7 deficit to beat the Bulls 41-24. At the time, Troy State was the number one, and make that the number three team in Division I AA. Back to receive, Jonathan Carter and DeMontre Carter.
Boy, DeMontre Carter, look out here, folks. He's averaging 40 yards per return this year. I'm sure that Mr. Gramatica is trying to kick the ball out of the end zone or away from him.
There he is. He leads Division I AA in kickoff returns. Played his high school football in Pensacola, Florida. Was one of the top high school recruits in the country. And the Bulls kick it away from him. That goes out of bounds, and the flag will come out, and Troy State will have excellent field position the very first time it touches the football. Obviously, Bill Gramatica, no way did he want to put the ball into the hands of DeMontre Carter.
I'm sure that Coach Leavitt mentioned to him that it might be a good idea if he didn't kick it to DeMontre.
Do you think it was a mention or an order?
No, I think it was a direct order, and of course, that's the danger of doing that. Now, you still give him good field position with the ball on the 35-yard line.
But then again, you consider the fact that DeMontre Carter is averaging 40 yards per return. Even though it's at the 35, the Bulls come out ahead by 5 yards.
Right, and you know, Al, you mentioned the wind, and that really was the key thing there because he was kicking into the wind, and we're gonna re-kick it here. And I missed the call by the official. I don't know exactly what happened there. I didn't see a flag. So we're going to re-kick it. And I think that probably Coach Leavitt is happy with that because you don't want to give it to him on the 35-yard line.
South Florida checking in at 2-2.
Okay. Okay, now we got
certainly
that squared away.
Either way.
Yeah, they have their choice. The receiving team can either ask them to re-kick it or they can take it on the 35. I've never seen a team not want to take it on the 35.
Huge difference between the 35 and 20-yard lines. And there's the starting quarterback at Troy State, Brock Nutter. He has started every game since 1998 when he was a redshirt freshman, 22-6 as a starter. Had a big game a week ago, 20 of 34 passes, 292 yards, 4 touchdowns in the big victory over Alabama State. Troy State begins at the 35-yard line. There's Carter. And there are the South Florida Bulls, Roy Manns and Leroy Selman Jr. in quickly for the tackle. Here's a look at the starting lineups for today's game brought to you by the Tampa Tribune. For the offense of Troy State, DeMontre Carter, again, a big-time talent, one of the top talents in Division I AA. Thad Boutone, an excellent fullback. McAlilly Carruthers are big-time players. They're both transfers, and they're all conference selections coming into the season. Nutter quickly to the air. He's got Jonathan Carter very close to a first down. Anthony Henry, the tackle for South Florida. And now the Tampa Tribune starting lineup for the South Florida Bulls. Hey, Selman Jr., Mitchell, the number one tackler on this team with 33 tackles and a veteran crew in the defensive backfield. Henry Davis, Manns, and Mize. It's good enough for a first down.
Yeah, Brock Nutter is really an outstanding quarterback. And boy, he looked like it on that first throw. He looked very confident.
He has thrown for at least two touchdown passes in every game this season. Carter tries to cut it inside, and again, the South Florida Bulls are right there, ready and waiting. Anthony Williams on the tackle for the South Florida Bulls, along with Jaquoy Blunts.
You know, the biggest difference in these two teams right here, and let's take a look at DeMontre Carter right here first. This guy can really fly, but look at the pursuit. You know, again, we always talk about South Florida's speed on defense. Look at that. Six green shirts right there. No chance for, I don't care how good a back is, he can't do anything against that.
It's a loss of two in the play. Now, let's remember this Troy State offense has an offensive line starting four seniors on that offensive line. That has also been a key in their offensive attack.
This is an audible right off the bat.
Second and long.
Nutter was looking for Haywood Skipper over there, and the flag comes out. Glenn Davis in coverage for the South Florida Bulls, and he may have been called for a penalty.
This is a Conference USA crew tonight, and that was a very, very close call. Had he got his head back to the ball sooner, you know, this would not have been thrown. Take a look at it right here. He's in good shape. He gets a good press on him right there. Now, just get your head back sooner. If he would have turned his head back inside, he would have, one, would have had a chance for an interception. Two, it certainly would not have been called interference.
Instead, it's a first down as Troy State moves into South Florida territory.
Well, I think for South Florida, if they can shut down the running game tonight like they have up to this point, you would like this team to be throwing every snap, really, because they run the ball extremely well.
Troy State 3-0 on the season. Wins over Alabama A&M, Appalachian State, and Alabama State. They've had 2 weeks to get ready for this ball game. From the 41-yard line, play action. Nutter in trouble, simply throws it away, and the Bulls want a flag. Leroy Selman Jr. with the pressure, and you have to wonder, was he outside the tackles in that situation?
Well, you know, the rule in college is different in that respect. But, I mean, you know, Carter was in the vicinity, so there's no way that would have been called a penalty, I think, in either respect. Let's take a look at it right here. This is what you call pretty good pressure on Nutter here. And, no, I don't think that's, I think that's a good no flag, honestly.
Leroy Selman Jr. looked a lot like Dad on that play.
Yeah, he did, didn't he?
Second down and long from the 41. Opening drive for Troy State. And again, a big-time tackle by the Bulls, Jaquoy Blunts. He is all over LeBaron Black. Black barely got to the line of scrimmage.
Let's take a look at this one right from the ground level. You're going to see it here. This is just the ball. He was unblocked from the backside. And again, the speed of Jaquoy Blunt manifests itself right there. That was terrific pursuit. You know, the biggest difference in these two teams is, of course, South Florida has played a better schedule, a tougher schedule. I think that makes you a better team.
Another loss on the play. Third down and long. The Bulls have been hurt by big pass plays on third down. From the shotgun, Nutter going deep. Once again, looking for Haywood. Haywood Skipper.
That was Kenny Robinson, the young freshman. And I'll tell you what, boy, the Bulls have a couple of young freshman DBs, and he's one of them that really looked good to me. That was a great play right there.
So that brings up fourth down.
That coverage, in pro terminology, was what's called an 11 coverage. You're man-to-man with a guy down the deep middle and a guy in the hole, and that's where the ball has to go. You got to throw it outside. So that was a good raid by Troy State.
DeAndre Rubin back to receive for the South Florida Bulls. We talked about Carter being a big-time returner for Troy State, number one in Division I-AA. DeAndre Rubin is number three in Division I-AA for punt returns, yeah, averaging 26 per return.
Yeah, these two return guys are really going to be fun to watch tonight.
Very, very high punt. Rubin calls for the fair catch, and Troy State is all over
this. Oh, boy.
Woo. So Markwell Blackwell will have his work cut out for him. deep inside South Florida territory, a 41-yard punt by Matt Allen. He is one of the top punters
in
Division
I-AA. Two great punters tonight with Matt Allen, and of course the Bulls have Devon Sanderson. Outstanding special teams for both teams. Good punters, good kickers, the sign of a good football teams.
So the South Florida Bulls will get the football at the 3-yard line. How about Markwell Blackwell last week at Baylor? 22 of 42, 236 yards and a touchdown, and he ran for 132 yards. First and 10, just underway. Al Keck along with Doug Graber at Raymond James Stadium. Raphael Williams cuts it back right side. He has a first down and more.
Boy, and he cut off of his outside foot there. Otherwise, he really had a chance to take that one considerably further. He cut on that outside foot and just slipped.
Here's a look at the Tampa Tribune starting lineups. For South Florida, Raphael Williams, the all-time leading rusher at the University of South Florida. Charlie Jackson back in the lineup. Again, a veteran offensive line for the South Florida Bulls. Raphael Williams, good gain on the play, gets a first down. Nobody in the backfield except for the quarterback, Markwell Blackwell. Three wide receivers split left side. Blackwell, quick pass. Charlie Jackson over the 20. Trying to fight his way to the 25-yard line, but he is brought down by Travis Bozeman. And the defensive starting lineup for Troy State. Betts, a transfer from South Carolina. Jimmy McClain, he's a man that had two interceptions for touchdowns last year against the South Florida Bulls. And the key guy to remember there in the secondary for Troy State, Travis Bozeman, he has three interceptions in three games this season. Second down and a yard. Reuben in motion. Raphael Williams tries to fight his way to the 25-yard line. He appears to be short of the first down. Nazir Yamini, the tackle for Troy State.
Yeah, this is imperative that you get a first down here when you start off second and two. You certainly would like your opportunities here. It's going to be third and looks like about 2 feet, Al. This is where a team like South Florida sometimes gets in trouble because, you know, they're a spread the field kind of offense. And when it comes to these short yardage situations, it's not really a part of their base offense.
You know, last week against Division I Baylor, the Bulls outgained Baylor 409 to 370, but four fumbles just killed this offense. The keeper, Markwell Blackwell, appears to have the first down. And he does. So this South Florida offense was backed up on its own 3-yard line, and the Bulls have come out with two consecutive first downs.
You know, and this offense is certainly getting better every single week. And boy, that's a real good push by Joey Sipp and the guards and tackles in there. McKenzie Fitz, excellent push on the quarterback sneak.
Ball marked at the 27-yard line. First and 10, just underway, no score. 9:42 and counting here in the first. Troy State, undefeated, 3-0, rated number one in Division I-AA, the Bulls 2-2. Quick handoff, Williams. He had some room momentarily, cuts it back, and gets to the 30-yard line. Nick Colbert with the tackle for Troy State.
You know, we're only into the first possessions for both teams. One thing that just jumps out as me as a coach looking at this game, both these defenses, Al Keck, run very, very, very well. Very athletic. The stars on this defense are certainly both defensive ends, Betts and Marable, and the backer, McClain, 45, is a heck of a player
and
as well.
And again, McClain just killed the Bulls a year ago. Two interceptions for touchdowns. The pitch, Williams tries to cut it back the other way, but you talk about disciplined defense. Jimmy McClain stayed in his lane and refused to give way, and the Trojans were there waiting for Williams.
Yeah, they sure were. And you know, that's just a part of this offense. When you spread out the defense like this, when they blitz, like, you know, they just can't pick him up, and you're gonna give up some minus plays. You're gonna make big plays, but you're gonna make up some minus plays. Therefore, it's hard to be consistent with this kind of offense.
First time the Bulls have faced third and long, third and 12. the shotgun. Blackwell with time, looking for a receiver. Remember, he threw for 132, or he ran for 132 yards last week. He goes out of bounds at the 35-yard line. He's well short of a first down.
Yeah, that's too bad because he really had some folks open on the scramble. He just couldn't quite get the ball to him. So we're looking at fourth and about four. Now the first time for Devon Sanderson on the field. Outstanding young punter for South Florida, just a redshirt freshman. Boy, this guy has really been impressive in replacing Tony Umholtz, who was in camp with the Tennessee Titans.
Sanderson, number eight in Division I, AA. Rayshon Reed back to receive, standing at his 30-yard line. Movement up front, no flag. Reed takes it at the 26. Tries to turn a corner and a beautiful tackle.
Boy, that's great
for South Florida. Kenny Robinson, excellent special teams. A 41-yard punt with a 5-yard return. Troy State will handle the football for the second time tonight. South Florida and Troy State live from Tampa. Midway through the opening period, number one Troy State and South Florida are scoreless. USF Athletics kicking off a new tradition this year for the Bulls fans, 12 and under. It's the Huntington Junior Bulls Club for a membership fee of only $20. Kids receive a Huntington Junior Bulls Club t-shirt and free admission to all USF Athletic home games the entire year. For information, stop by your local Huntington Bank location or visit www.gousfbulls.com. Opening play, Anthony Williams, the tackle on DeMontre Carter for Troy State.
Boy, DeMontre Carter has never been shut down like this. He really has had no opportunity tonight. It looks to me, Al, like the South Florida defense up front has really, really come to play. They're getting after Troy State up front.
Carter, again, one of the top running backs in Division I AA. Three carries so far for only 1 yard, but he's so dangerous. He can come up with a big play any time of the ball game, so you have to watch him very carefully. Nutter to the air again. He finds Haywood Skipper, and that is good for a first down. Anthony Williams, the linebacker, with the tackle for South Florida.
And if there's been a problem for South Florida defensively this year, they have had trouble rushing the passer. They just have not really gotten much done up front rushing the passer. And this looks like Chikoy Blunt coming off, and if that's him, then that they don't need that to happen because he's one of their outstanding pass rushers. But you know, that's the only criticism you could have of the South Florida defense up to this point this year.
Good for a first down. Netted two of four, 24 yards, both passes. Good for first down. Here's Carter with a big hole, left side, spinning move. He's brought down by Glenn Davis, and that may have been a touchdown-saving tackle.
Well, without question it was. And you can see right off the bat and quickly why you don't want to give this guy much of an opening. Look at this right here. Boy, he's got great quickness and speed. That's a great open field tackle by Davis because otherwise, Al, you're exactly right. He is out the gate.
Gain of 9 yards on the play. Second down and one at the 44-yard line. Carter has also caught some long passes for touchdowns as well. A 78 and 67 yarder against Appalachian State. Coming out of nowhere, a big time hit for the Bulls and a fumble. Thurman Edwards with the sack, and Nutter had no idea that Edwards was on his back.
Folks, if you ever want to know what a blind side hit is, this is it right here. He had no idea it was coming, and very, very fortunate that that ball bounced right back up to him.
Thurman Edwards, the senior out of Lake Wales.
Anthony Henry, they were trying to run, and that's what they do, they run those post patterns, and Anthony Henry had great coverage on Jonathan Carter going down the post. That's why he had to hold the ball.
Third down and seven from midfield, still scoreless. The last time out, Troy State scored 31 points in the opening period. Nutter under pressure, again looking deep, coming back to the football. was Chad Lucas. Excellent coverage downfield by the South Florida Bulls. Anthony Henry nearly picked that pass off. Yeah,
Anthony Henry is really doing a good job making the transition from safety to corner. A good pressure on the quarterback right here. Again, good coverage downfield forces him to hold the ball. Now watch. The key thing right here for Anthony Henry is he turns his back to the ball, almost comes up with a pick.
Once again, Matt Allen back to punt. Charlie Jackson standing near his 10-yard line. Matt Allen, again, one of the better punters in all of college football, averaging more than 44 yards per punt. Had a 41-yarder the first time out, and this is another very high punt. Jackson just calls a fair catch and then tries to take off with it. We don't see. Now, they're saying that possibly Troy State may have touched the football, but there's a flag back near the line of scrimmage.
That's in the area of roughing the kicker, although I certainly didn't see anything. I'd be anxious to see what this call is.
A 38-yard punt for Matt Allen.
Boy, does he get great hang time. Wow. Just absolutely outstanding special teams with both of these football teams. This is going to be a great battle to watch tonight.
Personal foul. First down.
Wow, boy, that is devastating. And, of course, we were both following the football. We didn't see it. Let's take a look right here. Let's take a look at it. Well, I'm sorry. He was blocked into the punter.
Vasse Marcus trying to make his case.
Yeah, that certainly should not have been a 15-yard penalty, in my opinion. He was blocked into the punter. And, in fact, he was thrown into the punter. I think the official missed that one.
Second penalty on South Florida. Two penalties for 30 yards, one on a pass interference penalty. The last time that Troy State had the football. Razzle dazzle, the end around, this time with Carter. He is tackled at the 25-yard line by Anthony Williams.
This offense really has two personalities. You know, they line up in a I formation and try to hammer you, and then Al, they'll take the same personnel and they'll spread out DeMontre Carter and the tight end and try to spread the field much like South Florida does.
Troy State on the move for really the first time tonight, this deep into South Florida territory. From the 25-yard line, first and 10, 4:15 counting in the opening period, still scoreless. Three wide receivers split left side. A screen pass, and the Bulls are right there. Anthony Henry coming up to tackle LeBaron Black.
And I think we have an illegal formation up at the top. That's what the official, to me, it was an illegal formation. Let's see if they were able to get it right.
It looked like one of the receivers still was not set.
I think you might want to think about turning this one down. You have a loss on the play.
And you get the down.
That's the big thing. But what a heck of a job by Coach Blakeney. Not too happy with that. They really had trouble with the formation.
Illegal position on the offense. Yep. Henry declined. Second down.
Good call.
So that'll set up second down and 12 from the 27.
Yeah, you have to do that. I mean, you know, anytime there's a loss on a play, you certainly want to use the down. Here comes the spread offense again. Now, this is normal personnel, but watch out for this number one, DeMontre Carter, out here in the slot.
He's in the slot at the bottom of your screen. Nutter in the shotgun, looking for a quick pass. Big time pressure by the Bulls. And right there, Sean Hay, the all-time leader in sacks at the University of South Florida, number 16 for his career.
That looked like to me that South Florida ought to audible to a blitz roll. That's a great job of Sean Hay. He just beats him one-on-one. But that was a blitz, and the tackle number 71, Currington, got beat badly by Sean Hay.
Currington is 6'7", 290 pounds. Sean Hay, 6'4", 250. He showed incredible quickness and strength to get right by Currington.
He's the all-time sack leader at South Florida with 15. He just added to that total.
Third down and 17. Nutter steps up, again under pressure. Can he get away? Flips it out, out of bounds, incomplete. All kinds of pressure on Nutter tonight by the South Florida front seven.
I'm gonna tell you what, Al. These are two very, very good football teams tonight, and this is going to be a terrific game. You could just see it. Both defenses are very good. A lot of speed on the field. I'll tell you, this is really going to be a great one to watch.
Fourth down and 17. The ball is on the 32-yard line, and coming in to attempt a field goal, Lawrence Tynes, 4 of 5 on the season, has a long of 36.
It's a 49-yarder where he's putting it down.
Watched him during warm-ups. Again, the wind has died down somewhat, but what wind there is behind his back.
He's 4 of 5 this year, and he's a darn good kicker. Both teams have got it all. They've got great punters, great return guys, great kickers.
Timeout, South Florida.
And the South Florida Bulls call a timeout with 3:29 left to go here in the opening period. Really the first opportunity for a scoring play for either team. 3:29 left to go in the first. Number one, Troy State, going after a field goal. Away, Larry Blakeney thinks better of a 49-yard field goal try. And punt now, Matt Allen. DeAndre Rubin sprained an ankle. And oh, how the Bulls would not want to lose what has to be their top receiving weapon on offense.
Boy, does that hurt. That really, really hurts. He's their one big play guy on offense.
Allen on the pooch kick, going for the sideline. And the Bulls get a lucky bounce there.
They really did. That was a great kick. I mean, it had to land about a foot. Landed right about at the 4-yard line, about a foot in bounds, and took a dead left kick right into the end zone.
Once again, the Bulls, for a while anyway, have lost DeAndre Rubin to an ankle injury. Rubin with 14 catches for 132 yards and 2 touchdowns. Also, their leading punt returner. And let's not forget that a year ago, Markwell Blackwell and DeAndre Rubin hooked up on a touchdown pass at Troy State to get the Bulls going. Now, the Bulls blew a 21-7 lead in that game. This is a very low-scoring game so far. Both teams have shown signs of moving the football. Blackwell, the quarterback draw. And Troy State was ready. Jimmy McClain did his homework. He was right there waiting for Markwell Blackwell.
Yeah, he had 130 yards rushing last week, and they're not going to let that happen again, are they, Al?
Absolutely not.
That was actually, that was a what they call the quarterback sweep. They run a quarterback draw. They run a couple of different quarterback draws. They have an option play. You know, Mike Canales knows he's got to get the ball in the hands of number 10 and allow him to make plays. He's the best playmaker on the field now, certainly, that DeAndre Rubin is out.
Blackwell, only a sophomore, 8-5 as a starter. Three of those losses to Division I teams. Raphael Williams, right up over center. Nazir Yamini on the stop for Troy State.
Troy State did an excellent job that time of moving into a blitz package late and not allowing Markwell Blackwell to audible away from the run. You know, that was really a dead play right from the start. Al Key, 3rd and 6 right here. They need to make something happen to keep, you know, to get their defense off the field.
Three wide receivers at the bottom of your screen. Again, the shotgun for Markwell Blackwell. 3rd and 6. Here comes a blitz. Blackwell has some room to run. Over the 30-yard line, good for a first down. O.C. Imanimura, the tackle. Let you say that name, but no, I jumped in for you.
I'm just going to call him the defensive tackle. Yeah,
you're the column number 72. I don't blame you.
Yeah, this is really where Markwell is best. Excellent move, and he knows where the marker is right there. Drives to the first down. That's a great job. That's where he's most dangerous. When he's out in space, he's got great quickness and moves. He can make people miss.
Again, three wide receivers at the bottom of your screen. Blackwell ran for 132 yards last week, already has 20. Excellent protection. Going back the other way, looking for McCready, and it's long. The pass was caught, but he may have been out of bounds. Delrick Jackson. And it is ruled incomplete. 2nd down and 10.
you know, and the reason that ball appeared to be overthrown, there was a lot of contact. You can't quite see it right here, but there was a lot, no question he's out of bounds, but there was a lot of contact about 10 yards earlier, and that is the reason McCready was not able to get to that ball. The timing was really pretty good.
Second down and 10 at the 31-yard line. Under 2 minutes, opening period. Number one, Troy State, 3-0. South Florida, 2-2. Blackwell, the pitch. Raphael Williams at midfield and barely pulled down by Jackson. Williams, yeah, one step from going all the way, a 19-yard gain for the Bulls.
Yeah, that's the shovel pass, and extremely well, very, very well, good execution. Shovel pass right there.
A lot of excellent guys in the neighborhood.
Yep, excellent, excellent execution by South Florida. That was a good job by Anthony McKenzie, number 67, pulling and trapping on the shovel pass.
South Florida near midfield for the first time offensively. 135 and counting here in the opening period, still scoreless. A blitz, quick pass. Hugh Smith at the 30, great speed near the 20-yard line, and the transfer from the University of Miami of Ohio with a big play, Travis Bozeman, the stop for Troy State, 26 yards on the game.
Yeah, they caught him in a blitz, man-to-man here, and here's the wide receiver screen to Hugh Smith. Oh, good block by Joey Sipp right there. Boy, he's got speed. Woo, he's got some speed. Good burst.
Again, the Bulls one step away from going all the way. Hugh Smith, a junior, again, a transfer from Miami of Ohio. Ball on the 22, first and 10, South Florida. First march as we're closing in on the end of the opening period. Blackwell under center. Pump fake. Coming back the other way, looking for McCready. Touchdown,
wow.
South Florida.
Whoa, what a catch by McCready. Woo! That's the best drive that I've seen this football team make this year, Alcat. And, you know, a lot of times, you know, all of a sudden, last week against Baylor, the offense really started taking off. And they just look like a different group of kids out there tonight. They have much more poise, confidence than Blackwell. It looks great. This is a, he's trying to pump and go deep down the other side, take it away. Look at this catch by McCready. Whoa, that's a big time play right there.
Martin Gramatica into attempt, make that Bill Gramatica into attempt. The point after, wishful thinking. And the kick is good, so the South Florida Bulls get first blood on the number one team in Division I AA. A 22-yard touchdown pass to the senior, Scott McCready from Tampa's King High School, and the South Florida Bulls take a 7-0 lead over the number one team in Division I AA, Troy State. An impressive drive, 80 yards, and not a whole lot of plays, Doug Graber.
No, and it was a series of big, really, there were three plays in that drive that easily could have gone out the gate and gone the distance. McCready, boy, that they're very, very lucky for him that he got a sixth year of eligibility. The NCAA granted that because of an injury situation. And again, let's take a look at this throw, Al Kick. I'll tell you, watch Blackwell pump off the other way to get the safety off of it. He throws, this is very, very well covered right there. And that is an excellent, excellent throw. That shows some maturity in growing up by that young quarterback right there.
You talk about this transition to Division I football. I'll tell you what, that was a major college football play at any level.
Oh, absolutely, no question about it.
Blackwell was 3 of 4 for 69 yards and the touchdown on that drive. He also ran for 9 yards. Gramatica, a line drive kick, goes through the end zone. And the South Florida Bulls will put their defense on the field for Troy State at the 20-yard line. 43 seconds left to go here in the opening period. And again, the Bulls strike first on Troy State.
Yeah, that's a good shot of Marquell on the sideline. And, you know, Coach Canales, the offensive coordinator, was telling me the best thing they've done in the last couple weeks, they've really simplified the offense. There was probably just a little bit too much thinking going on out there. And you can see it because they look like they're playing loose and relaxed, and they know exactly what they're doing.
First and 10 from the 20, draw play. Carter, very little running room. Kawika Mitchell among the tacklers.
You know,
along with Thurman Edwards.
Kawika Mitchell is, and Thurman Edwards, they're both playing very well tonight. Kawika Mitchell is a guy that is really starting to come into his own this year. A transfer from Georgia, and a kid that certainly was going to play there. Number five, he's really starting to become a very, very good football player.
Second down and 8 from the 22. 10 seconds left to go in the opening period. Carter again with the hole, but again, the Bulls very quick to convert. Roy Mann's coming up from a strong safety position to slam the door. And that is the end of the opening period. The South Florida Bulls, a 22-yard touchdown pass from Markwell Blackwell to Scott McCready, and the South Florida Bulls own a 7-0 lead over the number one team in Division I-AA. The Bulls lead Troy State by a score of 7-0. We'll come back with the second period of action live from Tampa, Florida, right after. We're back for the second period of action. The South Florida Bulls again. A 22-yard touchdown pass. Markwell Blackwell to Scott McCready. The last time the Bulls had the football, this sets up now. Third down and 4 on the 26. And South Florida would love to get the football back for Markwell Blackwell. This defense so far for the South Florida Bulls has given up some yards, but any time that Troy State has come up with a crucial third down inside South Florida territory, the Bulls have held.
Yeah, and to me, the most important thing for the Bulls defense tonight is, with the exception of the one play, they really have shut down the running game pretty much. And now, I think a very key thing is, because the wind seems to be picking up, Al, now they have the wind at their backs here in the second quarter.
Troy State 0 for 3 on third down conversions. And again, Troy State is now going into this wind, and I don't know if we can get a shot of the goalpost, but the wind has really kicked up. Third down and 4 from the 26. Bulls lead 7-0, just underway, second period. Nutter. Carter gets away from one tackler, and it appears he has enough for a first down. Roy Manns, the tackle, but the Bulls nearly had Carter behind that first down marker.
Yeah, they really did. Anthony Henry's, that was the first play tonight where he hasn't made the big play when he had a chance, because he really could have easily had him. And, you know, then they got the punter on the field, but didn't quite get it done right there. And again, you know, in his defense, DeMontre Carter in the open field is a load.
Had a big career at Auburn before transferring. In fact, had 102 yards against Alabama in that big cross-state rivalry. Had more than 100 yards in a victory over Georgia. Nutter. Hands off to his big fullback, Bouton. Bouton, a load over midfield down to the 45-yard line. Vasse Mark and Glenn Davis both went for a ride before they finally haul him down.
250-pound Thad Bouton from Atlanta, Georgia. They just kind of caught him napping here. They really had a big crack right there. Missed tackle by Butler. Davis is going for a ride there, isn't he?
24 yards on the game. Bouton averages 5 yards every time he touches the football, and at 6 feet, 250 pounds, all muscle, I can see why.
He is a load, isn't he? He's a big fella. Good blocker, excellent blocker.
From the 46, the pitch to Carter. Carter trying to work his way through. He has a crease, he has a lane, he loses a shoe, and he gets in for the touchdown.
Well,
46 yards with one shoe.
Yeah, Jay Bice came up and was not able to get him down, got the shoe off, but he looked like he may have picked up speed when he lost the shoe. That's what you worry about with DeMontre Carter. It's just a matter of time. He has so much speed that he's gonna make big plays. Excellent block by Bouton in the left tackle. There's the block right there on Davis. There's the missed tackle right there, and away he goes. And buddy, look, no, he ran right out of his shoe. Well, you can see why he's a big-time player.
Carter, 8 carries, 72 yards. The answer on the point after by Tynes is good, and just like that, Troy State ties the football game at 7. DeMontre Carter 46 yards for the touchdown. Carter with his third touchdown of the season, number 5 overall, running out of his shoe for Paters. The South Florida offense showed some big plays the last time it touched the football. This time, Troy State's turn. DeMontre Carter, 46 yards on the touchdown. That wraps up a 5-play, 80-yard drive. And let's remember, the Bulls had this football team in a 3rd and 6. They still go down and score a touchdown.
Yeah, the first quarter was really kind of cat and mouse. You know, both teams moved the ball, but neither team could score. South Florida scores. Troy State comes right back, answers the bell. They stick it in the end zone. This, you could just see it coming, Al Keck. This game is going to go back and forth all night long.
Lawrence Tynes, who added the point after, will kick off and back to receive for the South Florida Bulls. Charlie Jackson and Hugh Smith. Smith is settling under this. Touched the football. Downs it.
That's a good job there. There was some indecision between Smith and Charlie Jackson as to who was going to handle that ball, and that really, really hurt because they had a chance for a great return. They did not take advantage of the fact that Troy State was kicking into the wind. That ball came down about the 7-yard line.
It looked like it touched Hugh Smith.
Yeah, that would be a muff throw into the end zone, and it really, as long as you, you know, cover the ball in the end zone, it doesn't matter.
From the 20-yard line, first down and 10. The last time the Bulls touched the football, they drove 80 yards for a touchdown. McCready in motion, already has one touchdown pass. Blackwell in trouble, finds McCready at the 24-yard line. Nazir Yamini, one of 4 tacklers for Troy State.
You know, and to me, as a coach, you know, evaluating and looking at this game, it looks to me like Markwell has much more poise in the pocket than he's had in the past. And the other thing is the offensive line looks a lot better. Ooh, that's a great job by Sip. Did you see that?
A great pancake.
That was a pancake.
3 wide receivers at the top of your screen. Blackwell again from the shotgun. 2nd down and 6. We're tied at 7. Handoff, Raphael Williams trying to fight his way to a 1st down at the 30-yard line. Just shy of a 1st down. Gain of 5 yards on the play.
This looks like it's going to be like about 3rd and 2, maybe 3rd and 1. Well, you're exactly right, Al. You got better eyes than I do.
It's the LASIK. No doubt about it.
I can remember a day when you couldn't have said the couldn't have told us exactly where that ball was spotted.
I felt like it was out here by Braille, you know. Tony Prado came through for me big time. 3rd down and short at the 29-yard line. We're tied at 7. Williams trying to fight his way through, and he loses yardage.
Well, that hurts.
That hurts on 3rd down. Jimmy McClain and Yamini. The tackles for Troy State. So instead of 3rd down and very, very short, it's now 4th down and 1 yard. And Devin Sanderson will have to punt the ball away.
I like the spread offense, but to me, that's certainly one of the things that creates a problem. When you just don't have the mentality to just smash the football and get a key 1st down.
Reed back to receive, standing at his 40-yard line. Sanderson at his 15. A fake punt, and the Bulls have a 1st down, and then they fumble. Derek Rackard. But the official says that Rackard was down at the 35-yard line. Some trickery by Jim Leavitt, and that's good for a 1st down.
Well, you know, trickery is fine, but execution is where it's at, and they executed the play extremely well. They just ran the short trap and the direct snap to the up back, and it was very well executed. Here you'll see it right here. Watch the trap. Right there. There's the kick out block. Excellent job. Excellent execution up front. And that takes some guts to make that call.
Absolutely, in this territory, especially against a team like this with the offense of DeMontre Carter. From the 35-yard line. Tough snap. Blackwell pulls it down. and he's able to get back to the line of scrimmage. Broken play. The tackle by Jackson.
You know, as much as Markwell Blackwell carries the football on the sweeps and the draws and the scrambles, he had two crucial fumbles last week against Baylor. And from a coaching standpoint, they have worked with him all week just like a running back, running all kinds of drills, trying to strip the football and everything else. His ball security is better tonight, no question about it.
It's a gain of 2 yards on the play, second down and 8 from the 37-yard line. Tied at 7, 10:44 incoming. Left to go here in the second period. The South Florida Bulls taking on the number one team in Division I AA. Blackwell with time. He finds McCready again at midfield. It's good for another first down.
You know, and with DeAndre Rubin out of the game, there's no question who the go-to guy is right now. Scott McCready, number 16.
He has a 22-yard touchdown pass, touchdown catch. Antonio Thompson, the tackle for Troy State.
Boy, that's a laser. That was a... I'll tell you, Mark Wells showed some real strength on that throw.
At the 48-yard line, the Bulls are on the march again. A crucial fourth down play, a fake punt, gave the Bulls a first down. Hand off, Raphael Williams gets a couple.
Raphael Williams with the ball.
Yeah, they're trying to pound the inside off the one back set. The two defensive tackles for Troy State, DeVern Williams, 290. And number 72, I'm not good, 6'4", 270, O.C. Omignora. Those two guys are really strong.
Let's take a Zephyr Hills water break. So far today, DeMontre Carter, 72 yards, including a 46-yard touchdown run. South Florida, 98 yards passing. Markwell Blackwell, the 22-yarder on the touchdown catch. And this water break has been brought to you by Zephyr Hills, natural spring water, pure water, and a pure place. Pass incomplete.
Well, I tell you what, I did not like what I saw right there. Leon Matthews quit on that ball. And, you know, you just don't do that. You keep going, Alkeck, because you can draw an interference penalty. There's a lot of good things. Nothing good can happen when you quit on the ball when it's in the air. He's got to learn how to go full out every single play. That's not good.
And let's remember that DeAndre Rubin left early in the opening period, the Bulls' leading receiver with an ankle injury. There's Matthews up at the top of the screen. The Bulls 2 of 4 so far on third down. Blackwell rolling left. He's got Matthews. It's good for a first down. This time Matthews comes back to the pass, and Nick Colbert knocks him out of bounds, but not before. The South Florida Bulls get a first down at the 34-yard line.
Yeah, and this is really a good throw by Blackwell. This is not an easy throw going to your left like this. And he really puts it right on the money. Good job by Matthews. Ball was thrown perfectly outside where the defender could not get to it. Really good execution.
This drive has stayed alive because of a fake punt on fourth down. The Bulls now at the 34, first and 10. We're tied at 7. 4 seconds on the play clock. Quarterback draw. Blackwell at the 20-yard line. Jimmy McClain, the linebacker, and Antonio Thompson with touchdown-saving tackles.
You know, it looks to me like this offense really grew up down in Waco, Texas last week, because I see much better execution all the way across. And the offensive line, to me, is the biggest difference. Good to see he had both hands on the football right there. That was terrific. Just as he was going down. He has not done that before this week in practice.
38 yards on the ground, 7 of 9 and a touchdown. 110 yards in the air for Markwell Blackwell. That was a 16-yard gain. 2 seconds on the play clock, and the South Florida Bulls call a timeout. Smart play as they are deep within Troy State territory. 8:37 left to go here in the second, and the Bulls don't want to make a mistake down here.
You know, and the personality of this game has really been interesting with you know, all of a sudden now good defense in the first quarter. Now both teams are going strong on offense.
We're tied at 7, 8:37 left to go before halftime. The Bulls and number one Troy State. We'll be back with more live from Tampa after this. We're tied at 7, but the Bulls are on the march at the 18-yard line. And have you heard? Florida's dairy farmers are inviting kids ages 10 to 12 to enter the Got Milk Junior Bulls Announcer Contest. You can join me and Doug Graber here in the broadcast booth for the October 21st game against Liberty. Tomorrow's the deadline, so enter online, floridamilk.com, or toll free, 1-866-511-MILK. 11th play of the drive. Blackwell with time. Looking for a receiver that cut one way. Blackwell threw it the other. Incomplete.
Well, that's a classic example of an option route where the receiver and the quarterback both have an option, and they did not read that correctly. Good protection up front. Excellent job. Anthony McKenzie right there, number 67. Very, very good.
This will be play number 12. Remember, this drive has stayed alive because of a fake punt on fourth down. Blackwell on the run, left side. He has some room at the 5 before he's bowled over. A fumble.
Oh, my God. That's a
and
touchdown.
And what a tough way to have this drive come to an end.
We're just talking about Marquell's done such a good job in the open field. Now, the officials are discussing this. Let's take a look here. If they recovered it, if Troy State recovered in the end zone, that's definite touchback.
But the question is whether or not he fumbled before he came down.
Yes,
now they're
did.
Calling
yep.
it a touchback.
It is a touchback. I think it's a very good call. That's a shame. He really got nailed. Now the question is, did he fumble? Watch here in space. Oh, he put his hat right on the football. That's a great job by the defense. Well, now, you know what? I guess it was ruled that the South Florida player did not have possession of the ball when it went out of the end zone. I think that's a good call.
That's tough way to end a drive.
What a great drive.
South Florida, especially when you think about Gramatica, may have had a chip shot for a field goal and the lead. Instead, the Bulls hand the ball over to Troy State at the 20-yard line. Nutter trips coming out. Finds a receiver at the 35-yard line. Good for a first down. And the receiver is Derek Byram.
Yeah, that was a terrific, terrific job. They ran what's called a stop route. He sold the go route. He turned it, and the timing was great. The ball was thrown really before he made the cut to Hayward Skipper right there. That was just a terrific job execution-wise on first and 10.
8:04 left to go here before halftime.
Nutter's been impressive.
Black gets near the 40-yard line and a host of Bulls tacklers. Thurman Edwards leading the way.
I wonder why DeMontre Carter is not in the game now.
He's coming off a long touchdown run, some 46 yards.
I see him on the bench over there. He looks fine. Maybe they're just giving him a blow on this series.
Second down and 7 at the 38-yard line. What a change in events here. South Florida on a long march, fumbles in the end zone. Troy State coming back the other way. Black again spins his way over the 45-yard line. Glenn Davis and Jay Myers, the tackles for South Florida.
This is, LeBaron Black is, he's another good running back out of Florida, Springfield, Florida. He has not played much this year.
Good for a first down at the 46. Play action. Nutter gets it away, and a beautiful tackle by Jay Mize coming up. And there's a loss on the play. Yeah, LaGrace Justice, the fullback, loses ground.
Great job by Mize right there. That was an inverted safety, and he's got the weak side force. That's the free safety coming up to make a tackle for a two-yard loss. That's a heck of a tackle in space. Jay Mize has had a very, very tough year, had the herniated disc in his neck at training camp, missed all of training camp, and really right now he's just starting to round into form. He missed spring football and missed all of training camp.
Mize at 175 pounds, gave up a ton of weight
to Justice at 235. Another pass, this time to Black. And Mize again on the tackle, but not before Troy State gets a first down.
Yeah, that was a busted coverage right there because they were definitely man-to-man, and one of the backers blew the call because he was wide open. And I'll tell you what, Jay Mize saved the touchdown right there because he's out the gate if he doesn't make that play. That's what Mize is saying right there. Who's got the back under flat, man-to-man?
Good for a first down at the 44-yard line.
You know, South Florida does a lot of audible in their whole defensive coverage based on backfield sets and everything else, and somebody did not get the communication there.
The fullback again. And again, close to a first down. LaGrace Justice, the carry. Tackled by Anthony Williams.
Now, this has been a very impressive drive by Troy State.
And again, after the fumble in the end zone by South Florida. South Florida would have had the football inside the five-yard line with the first down, first and goal for
them. First and goal.
And instead, Troy State, the number one team in the country, marching back the other way. But the game tied at 7. Black so far, 4 carries, 17 yards.
Well, turnovers have certainly been the Achilles heel of South Florida. Cost them a win last week, no question about it, against Baylor.
Second down and 2. Movement on the line, the South Florida Bulls.
Now, the tight end moved, and
Adrian
Hay reacted to that. Now, let's see that. Now, the tight end can move and reset. Let's see how the officials sort this one out. Yep.
False start on Adrian Moore.
Well, that changes things. Now it's 3rd and 7. Yeah, he flinches right there, and that's a good job of Sean Hay reacting to that.
Sean Hay, the junior. Been a starter for 3 years for the South Florida Bulls. So instead of, again, 2nd down and 2, now you're talking 2nd down and 7 at the 41-yard line. And both teams with 2 penalties tonight, but South Florida's have been the long variety. Black, good blocking up front. Anthony Williams pulls him down at the 35-yard line. This will set up 3rd down and very short.
Yeah, very short. And, you know, this Black has been impressive, too. I tell you, they have a couple of real scooters back in the tailback spot. He's not the 205 pounds. You know, Coach Kravitz here, the defensive coordinator for South Florida, Troy State alum, you know he'd like to get this win tonight for a lot of different reasons.
They have to get to the 34-yard line, 3rd down and 1. Black again, he has the first down. Bessé Mark, the tackle for South Florida at the 32-yard line, 1st down and 10 for Troy State. 4:17 left to go here in the first half. Black with 17 yards on 5 carries. Most of the carries on this drive. And DeMontre Carter is back into the ballgame for Troy State.
Along with Bouton, the big 250-pound fullback.
Carter with a 46-yard touchdown run the last time he touched the football.
Same play.
What a tackle by the Bulls. Bassett Mark with the honors.
Bassett Mark on the Butkus Award list. And I'll tell you what, you can see that he looks like he deserves it right here. He just flat beats the block, straight up the field, beats the block of the fullback, just quite, can't quite see it. Excellent open field tackle. Vasse Mark is really an outstanding linebacker. He and Kuika Mitchell and Anthony Williams and Jason Butler, it's a pretty darn good crew for South Florida.
A loss of 4 yards on the play, second down and 14. Carter again jumps over one tackler, and the Bulls pull him down inside the 30-yard line. Once again, it's Jamon.
Now this brings up a crucial third down situation here again. Third, and what do you say, Mr. Lasix, about four or five?
Looks like it's third down and five. Leroy Selman Jr. was hurt on the play. He's limping off the field.
And he's had a slight ankle problem, and he looks like he might have aggravated that.
A huge third down play here in the second period. 2:35 left to go. Third down and five. We're tied at seven. Nutter under pressure, and this will be incomplete. Knocked away by the Bulls. Vasse Mark knocked down the pass, so the Bulls defense holds on third down.
Well, Vasse Mark certainly made two key plays on that drive. On first and 10 and on third down, he made the two key plays. Good pressure. Well, look at it. Look at that vertical. I mean, he got up, but he had no place. He had to just flip it over and get rid of it. He was right in the throwing lane.
Lawrence Tynes on the field. He'll try a 44-yard field goal. Has a long of 36. He's kicking into the wind.
He's 4 or 5 this year.
Good snap, good hold, and the kick is good. And Troy State takes a 10-7 lead. The Trojans recover a fumble in the end zone for the South Florida Bulls. They take it back for a field goal the other way, and Troy State takes a 3-point lead. You can call that a 6-point turnaround for the South Florida Bulls and Troy State. South Florida on the march, appeared to have a field goal in its hip pocket, fumbles the football. Troy State takes it back the other way for a 44-yard field goal by Lawrence Tynes. And Troy State, the number one team in Division I AA, takes a 10-7 lead. It was a 6-minute drive, 12 plays, 53 yards. And with some of the big plays on that drive, Doug Graber, the Bulls defense has to be happy with the fact that they only gave up a field goal.
Well, absolutely. And of course, Vasse Mark made the two key plays.
Tynes with a short kick into the wind. Hugh Smith at the 6-yard line. Quickly over the 25 to the 28-yard line. And the Bulls, with 2:12 left to go in the first half, will take it from there. A 21-yard return for Hugh Smith. Leroy Selman on the bench came off the field with an ankle injury, talking to the trainers. Again, 6 minutes, 1 second, 53 yards. The 44-yard field goal by Tynes. 10-7, Troy State. South Florida with the football at the 26-yard line. Raphael Williams fights his way over the 30. Good gain on first down. 2:05 left to go in the first half.
Father, we're in the no-huddle offense now, and this is really down to 1:56, and the clock is running.
1:50 and counting. 3-point lead for the number one team in the country. Blackwell. Charlie Jackson at the 40, and he is leveled.
Yeah, that was
Rashawn Reed.
He said, hello.
Rips him. 1:37 remaining. The first down for the South Florida Bulls.
Clock stops at college football on a first and 10 here in 2 minutes.
And if the Bulls can get into field goal territory, Bill Gramatica will have the win on a field goal try.
Let's.
Blackwell gets away from it. Quick pass, McCready. At the 43-yard line, 1:20 in counting. Second and 5. A lot of time. Marching off the clock now with 1:10. McCready, 4 catches. 46 yards and the touchdown. 1:04 left to go. The Bulls having trouble on this series. Now under center. Matthews, good for a first down at the 43-yard line. Reed the tackle for Troy State.
See, and it really hurts now that South Florida had to use two timeouts earlier in the half here because this kills you now. Otherwise, you know, you take a timeout right there and you save, you know, at least 30 seconds on this drive.
Gramatica has a long of 51 yards. Blackwell under pressure simply throws it away. He Next. Was nailed by DeVern Williams.
That's really good poise there. Stop the clock. Now he really needs to get about 18 to 20 yards more to get Gramatica really in good field position here. They do have one timeout left if they happen to get caught in bounds.
34 seconds left to go before halftime. Troy State and Larry Blakeney with a 10-7 lead. Blackwell so far 10 of 14, 133 yards in the air, and the touchdown also has 56 yards on the ground. Blackwell with time. Matthews another first down with 27 seconds.
That stops the clock.
At the 27-yard line, there is a flag down and a holding penalty.
Oh,
this will come back and another backbreaker for the South Florida Bulls.
Oh, does that hurt? Because you're sitting right there with the timeout left and in field goal range with a kicker like Gramatica. You know, you'd like to think you can almost put those 3 points on the board.
Holding on the offense. 10-yard penalty. Previous spot. Repeat. Take it out.
Oh, boy. Let's take a look. Let's see if we can see it anyplace. Right there at the right of your screen, you can see it right there, the left tackle. That's a good call. He pulled him down, no question about it. That looks like 74, Kenyatta Jones.
That one hurts.
Really
from
hurts.
The 47-yard line now, second down and 20. Make that third down. No, second down and 20, I'm sorry. Blackwell trying to hit Matthews again, incomplete. 11 seconds remaining. And the Bulls still have a timeout remaining. And they have another offensive lineman hurt down on the 45. The Bulls have to go 20 yards to get a first down. 11 seconds and the timeout remaining. They could have a decent play and still have time to call timeout and bring Bill Gramatica on the field. By the way, at halftime, we will talk with Leroy Selvin to tell us about some of the fundraising events going on for this football program here at the University of South Florida. Kenyatta Jones able to jog off the field.
Yeah, Al, the key element here is you have a timeout left. Of course, again, if they could throw a deep comeback or a deep throw down the middle of the field and get a completion, clock stops on the first and 10, have all kinds of time still. But boy, this is third and 20 is a kind of a tough percentage-wise. You don't convert these too often.
And remember, the Bulls had the ball within Gramatica range only to come back because of the holding penalty. From the shotgun, third down and 20. Blackwell tries to step up, in trouble, looking for McCready.
That's interference.
And the Bulls want a flag.
Oh, boy.
Delrick Jackson in coverage. And the crowd here at the University of South Florida, Raymond James Stadium, cannot believe it.
Well, he's pretty much clearly on his back right there before the ball gets there. The reason the flag wasn't thrown is in the opinion of the official, the ball was overthrown. But, there was clearly contact before the ball got there. You know, at home, you'd like to think you'd maybe get those calls. And believe me, there is a difference playing at home and on the road.
And this is the Conference USA crew.
Okay,
three-point lead for number one Troy State.
Got to throw it up here now. Got to throw it up to the end zone.
4 seconds remaining. Again, pressure from Troy State. Blackwell is hit as the ball leaves his hand. Tim Betts the coverage and the hit. And that's the end of the first half. The number one team in Division I-AA, Troy State, with the field goal.
That's a heck of a first half of football. I mean, this is a good way to get a quarterback hurt right here when he's, boom, right. Yeah, that's a good way to get hurt. Okay, we're going to have Coach Leavitt here now to talk about this first half briefly before he heads into the locker room.
Full night here in Tampa, Florida, a little breezy, but it hasn't played much of a, really haven't, hasn't had much of an effect so far. Here's Troy State, owns a three-point lead over the South Florida Bulls. South Florida coming into the ballgame at 2-2. Troy State, number one in the country in Division I-AA. They are 3-0. Let's check out the halftime stats. Both teams have shown that they can run the football. Of course, 46 yards of that for Troy State coming on the touchdown run by Carter. And South Florida has done a good job passing the football against this Troy State defense. 221 yards of offense against an excellent defense, Doug Graber.
Yeah, you know, and the time of possession has been just about dead equal. It's been a great, great first half of football. The one turnover being the key stat of the whole first half. You can take a look at the yardage all you want, but that turnover was absolutely devastating. And, you know, that was not a careless fumble by Markwell. That was a great hit by Troy State defense. They put their hat right on the ball. Here it is right here, and right there's the hat right on the football, and out it comes. And, of course, not a good bounce at all because they really had a chance to recover it in the end zone. I think it was Charlie Jackson right there that had a chance to recover it, but not a very good bounce.
Jim Leavitt and company back on the football field, knowing they have their opportunities and now trailing by three against Troy State. And it's an opportunity to see DeAndre Rubin as he's walking back onto the field. The Bulls lost him to an ankle injury very early in the first half. He, of course, one of their top weapons offensively, and it's obvious he is done for the day, but walking fairly well on that bad ankle. I would like to take the opportunity to kind of brag a little bit here about my partner, Doug Graber, of course, just recently named the new head coach in NFL Europe of the Frankfurt Galaxy. I love the helmet, and what a program there in Frankfurt, Coach Graber, because you're talking about a program that draws consistently 40, 45,000 for every game there in Germany.
Well, first of all, thank you very much, Al, and I'm really, really excited. This picture was from the press conference in Frankfurt last week, and I'm so impressed with NFL Europe, and in particular the fans of the Frankfurt Galaxy. And you know, the NFL is really doing very, very well across the pond, so to speak.
Good crowd here at the University of South Florida tonight on a beautiful night as we get ready for the second half of action. South Florida trailing by three. And again, really, you think about the fumble in the end zone. Troy State comes back. That was a six-point turnaround because the South Florida Bulls at least had three from Bill Gramatica, maybe more, and the South Florida Bulls easily could own the lead at this point.
Yeah, and certainly the holding penalty in the two-minute drive at the end of the half was definitely a factor because they were really in field goal range at that time when that flag came. So I don't care, you know, forget the score right now. This has been a great half of football, and I can't wait to see these two teams go at it in the second half. Two very, very good football teams. Forget 1AA, forget transition, forget all that stuff. These are two good teams going at it. And, you know, next year, Troy State, just to give you an idea, next year they play Miami, Nebraska, Maryland, and Mississippi State. So these are two programs definitely on the rise.
And next week, the South Florida Bulls take on the number one team in Conference USA, number 22, Southern Miss. Back to receive now for the South Florida Bulls. Hugh Smith and Charlie Jackson. The Bulls won the toss, deferred to the second half, and times will kick off. Hugh Smith at the five. Has blocking, beautiful spin. Can he turn the corner? Gets up to the 30 before he's bowled over.
just too much speed. Troy State has too much speed to try to reverse your field like that. And of course, both teams are very, very similar in that respect. Very athletic, a lot of speed, a lot of Florida kids on that Troy State roster as well. And that's, of course, one thing that this state is really blessed with.
David Filion, the tackle and special teams. South Florida Bulls with the football here to open the second half. First and 10, they trail by a field goal. From the 28-yard line, this is South Florida's best field position of the night. Quick pass, Charlie Jackson. He's able to turn the corner. He's got the first down and more. He has one man to beat. McCready tried to get the angle on the block, and Charlie Jackson, I think, was watching McCready and simply ran out of bounds. A 44-yard gain, he could have gone more.
Yeah, he really could have, and that was just a mistake in judgment by Charlie Jackson. He won't want to see that on film. They faked the draw play to Raphael Williams, get it out, and I really thought it was a dead play. And I'll tell you what, Charlie Jackson put on a burst right there, and a great block by Matthews is really what sprung him. And watch this. He just kind of loses track of I don't know. I don't understand
that
exactly.
He jogged off the field holding his hamstring. So it may have been a hamstring injury. But either way, a huge play, 44 yards. First and 10 from there. Blackwell with time.
Wide open.
He has Guerrero wide open inside the 5-yard line. Richard Guerrero, his fourth catch of the season. Antonio Thompson in coverage. And the Bulls are knocking at the door inside the 5. 25 yards on the play.
Markwell had great execution there. He faked the flare to Raphael Williams and then threw up a strike to Guerrero. And that's a terrific adjustment by that young tight end coming back on the ball.
It looked like the pass may have been long, but Guerrero sells out. He goes all the way out to pull it in.
Yep, out of Miami, Florida, Braddock High School.
Blackwell now 12 of 19 and even 200 yards. Hugh Smith in motion. Raphael Williams tries to bust his way through. Not a whole lot of room there. They may have gotten to the 4, maybe the 3.
Now, in the past, and just as I speak, I was going to say, in the past, this has been Otis Dixon territory, and out comes number 21. The dump truck is out on the field. He's been a very, very reliable ball carrier down in here inside the 5-yard line.
Already has 2 touchdowns this season. Had 12 touchdowns back in 1998. In fact, he was the offensive MVP last year. He left early with a knee injury. He's lined up the tailback. Rackard, the fullback. Second and goal from the 5. McCready in motion. Play action. Looking for Guerrero again. Yep. Here comes a flag.
I guess so.
Travis Bozeman gets caught red-handed.
You know, when he was taking no chances, I mean, he just tackled him.
And it appeared that pass may have been high, but the way Guerrero is able to go up for the football, you can't take anything for granted.
Yeah, that was really very good imagination on the part of they faked the reverse. And now, you know, this is something I have not seen before.
At the half, first down.
You have Kawika Mitchell in the game now. Very well executed play, fake the reverse. And they really had him faked out. And of course, tackle Guerrero in the end zone.
Fourth play of the drive, again, Kawika Mitchell, the linebacker, now lining up at fullback in front of Otis Dixon. First and goal from the 3. Dixon pulled down at the 2. Rashawn Reed, the cornerback, coming up to make the tackle.
You know, I think he actually lost a yard, I think, on that play. Well, again, we've talked about it before tonight. When you have a spread offense, you know, this is a concern, your ability to get the tough yardage and goal line and short yardage, because, again, that's not really the personality of your team. That's why you're seeing Kawika Mitchell in here right now.
Second and goal from the 2. Dixon, the running back. McCready in motion. Here's Dixon again with blocking. Fights his way through.
Touchdown.
Touchdown, South Florida. Otis. Curtis Dixon with the honors from the 2-yard line, and the Bulls have regained the lead.
Al, I'll tell you, this has been a great, great football game,
and it's going to just keep on going. It's going to be a heck of a struggle back and forth all night long. Good ground level shot right here in the dump truck. Otis Dixon, good push. Can't quite, he's somewhere in that pile. You can't quite see him.
And Gramatica adds the point after, and just like that on the opening drive of the second half, the South Florida Bulls, thanks to a 44-yard pass play to Charlie Jackson, gets the Bulls in position. Another big pass to Richard Guerrero, and the South Florida Bulls set up Otis Dixon, and it is time to dance here at Raymond James. Say it loud, say it proud, the Bulls lead by 4. The opening drive of the second half, and the South Florida Bulls take it 72 yards and only 5 plays. Otis Dixon finishes things off with a 2-yard touchdown run, and the South Florida Bulls have regained the lead on the number one team in Division I-AA, Troy State, 14-10, South Florida. Blackwell, 2 of 2 in the passing department, 67 yards on the drive. Of course, the big play, a 44-yard pass to Charlie Jackson on the opening play of the second half for the South Florida Bulls, and that got things going for the Bulls as they now own a 4-point lead over Troy State. There's Rocky the Bull. He has reason to celebrate and dance. There it is, Dixon on the 2-yard run, thanks to the block in front of him by the linebacker and part-time fullback, Kawika Mitchell. And the Bulls kick off. Jonathan Carter, 2 yards deep. He has some blocking, and he's brought down at the 20-yard line, a 22-yard return.
That was Anthony Williams, and if he doesn't make that tackle, that one might be out the gate. Boy, these special teams on both these teams, I mean, you know, every snap is a chance for something big to happen. Right, now, let's see if Brock Nutter can answer the call, because that was a great drive by his counterpart, Marquell Blackwell.
Now, the last time the South Florida Bulls took the lead, Troy State came right back with an answer, and it was DeMontre Carter on a 46-yard touchdown run. And Carter is at tailback. Play action. Nutter looking for Jonathan Carter. Incomplete. Excellent coverage by Anthony Henry.
And Anthony Henry has really progressed nicely as this season has gone on as a cornerback. And I'll tell you what, I really think that young guy with his size and speed has got a future in this game.
Troy State, third straight drive, starting at its own 20-yard line.
You know, and going on about Anthony Henry, Al, I think he's found a home. To me, he looks much more comfortable at corner than he ever did at safety.
Here's Carter again, so quick. Big hit by Jay Mize.
Yeah, that was
at the 25-yard line, just when it appeared that Carter may be ready to take off. Roy Manns also in on the tackle.
Roy Manns and Jay Mize both, boy, they really lowered the boom right there. Boy, so explosive, both these football teams.
All right, you play Roy Manns.
You be the safety. You got to come up and make the play right there. There's Jay Mize, and there's Roy Manns, the two teammates from East Lake High School in Palm Harbor. High school teammates, college teammates, all the way through for those two young men.
Third down and 5. Big third down for the South Florida defense. Flag down. Free play. Really too bad, because South Florida puts the pressure on Nutter, and instead of setting up fourth down and long, this may be a first down for Troy State. Ja'Coy Blunt may have gone over the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, they had a full blitz coming, and you know, when you're blitzing, sometimes guys get a little antsy.
Offside, out of defense. It's all in a penalty, will be a first down.
Injuries have hurt this football team tonight. Penalties have hurt this football team tonight. And there's Jim Leavitt talking to Ja'Coy Blunt.
Injuries have hurt this team as well. That was a devastating loss, because now you lose your big play guy on punt returns, kickoff returns, and of course also as a receiver.
Four penalties for 45 yards for the South Florida Bulls. Seems everyone has been on third down. Nutter going deep, looking for Jonathan Carter. Off his fingertips, and he had six written all over that. Nutter knows he had an opportunity. Carter, it appeared, may have had a case of alligator arms. Look at this.
Yeah, he sure right had a step on him right there, and that was a terrific throw by Brock Nutter. And in talking to some of my friends in the press box before the game, scouts for the Raiders and the Browns and a couple other teams, they really like Jonathan Carter. So that obviously that doesn't happen too often.
He's a senior from Linville, Alabama. Three touchdowns, the leading receiver coming into this ball game for Troy State. Missed an opportunity there. Second down and long. Nutter has now misfired on his last four passes.
Well, that sets up a third and 10 now. This is a great opportunity for to get this defense off the field and give this opportunity another chance with pretty good field position.
Already 120 yards on the ground for Troy State. And the leading tacklers for the South Florida Bulls, defensive backs, Jay Mize, Anthony Henry. You don't want that.
No.
2-6 on third down plays. Black on the catch. And again, a great tackle over there for the South Florida Bulls. Anthony Henry grabbed Black and refused to let him slip away.
You know, Al, that's the identical play that earlier in the game on third and five, Anthony was not able to make the play. This time, excellent open field tackle. Get the punter on the field.
Matt Allen checks in. He'll stand at his 21-yard line. Charlie Jackson having trouble with the hamstring on the long play on the opening drive of the second half, standing at his 25-yard line, so he appears to be fine. Third punt tonight for Allen. Low snap. What a beautiful punt into the wind.
Wow.
Charlie Jackson calls a fair catch. And the Bulls will have the football at the 22-yard line. 10-18 left to go here in the third quarter. The South Florida Bulls march for a touchdown the last time they had the football, and they own a four-point lead over the number one team in the country. Doug Graber back here at Raymond James Stadium. The Bulls lead by four in USF Athletics, kicking off a new tradition this year for Bulls fans 12 and under. It's the Huntington Junior Bulls Club. And for a membership fee of only $20, kids receive a Huntington Junior Bulls Club t-shirt and free admission to all USF Athletic home games for the entire year. Check out the Bulls website at gousfbulls.com. From the 22-yard line, first and 10 for the South Florida Bulls. Blackwell, nearly picked off it is. Delrick Jackson. Watched that play the whole way. It looked like Blackwell watched the receiver going downfield, Chris Iskra.
Yeah.
And Blackwell gets careless.
This looks like a miscommunication to someplace. Markwell expected the receiver to stop. He kept going. Again, that's a fatal combination when you do not run an option route correctly. If both players aren't on the same page, you'll get no better example than that right there. That really, really hurts, especially after a good stand by the defense.
Blackwell and Iskra had trouble earlier in the ball game on a similar type of play, and again, they cannot hook up there. It's an interception. Good field position for Troy State. Carter. Roy Manns coming in with the tackle. And will this be a case of deja vu where South Florida had trouble with turnovers a week ago at Baylor, a Division I team? Even though they outgained the Baylor Bears, they lose the game because of turnovers.
Yeah, number one stat, number one thing that really causes teams to lose football games. Forget all the other stats. Turnovers are number one.
Second down and long from the 43-yard line. Play action. Nutter under pressure, and the Bulls get to him again. They're saying the pass was incomplete. Ja'Quoy Blunt with the big pressure on Nutter, and the Bulls were hoping they would have called this a sack.
Yeah, you can credit that to Ja'Quoy Blunt all the way. All the coverage was really pretty good, too. He just flat beats the offensive tackle right there.
Boy, Nutter got that off just in time.
Yes.
Third down and 10.
That was Charles Thomas, 74.
Troy State 2 of 7 on third down, but the Bulls have had trouble with penalties on third down so far tonight. This series after a South Florida interception, a blitz by the Bulls. Hayward Skipper, nowhere to go. Glenn Davis coming up to make a huge tackle. And Jim Leavitt, so happy with his defense after Markwell Blackwell gives up the interception, and the Bulls defense holds.
You know, in the second half now, this South Florida defense looks like they're in a position to possibly take over this game. That was a great drive right there. They were straight man-to-man. Again, Al, that was that what we call 11 coverage again. And that was just a terrific job of fighting through the blocks to get to the screen.
Matt Allen in the punt, a fourth time tonight. For Troy State, what a beautiful punt. Charlie Jackson calls the fair catch at the 15-yard line, make it the 14, and South Florida will get the football back. So even though Markwell Blackwell gives up a turnover, the Bulls, all they lose is field position, a 32-yard punt, and the Bulls will get the football back. All right. Now, two crucial turnovers so far for Markwell Blackwell. The fumble, the interception, coming off the fumbles last week. Does this start to play in his mind now?
Well, knowing his personality the way I do, I really don't think so. I think that he's going to just keep letting it go, and it's important that he does that. He doesn't want to freeze up.
At the 15, Raphael Williams gets back to the line of scrimmage. Vernon Marable on the stop for Troy State.
You know, and just to expand on that question again, Al, you know, South Florida's offense is, they depend on Markwell Blackwell. He's the man. I mean, you know, they have to spread the field. They can't be successful running the football every snap against Detroit State. They have to let Blackwell do what he does best. That's improvise, that's make plays, scramble, draws, get him the football. He's going to make the plays for you, especially with Ruben out.
He's only a sophomore, 8-5 as a starter. Has time, finds Hugh Smith. Smith turns the corner, can he keep his feet? At the 30, cuts back, still going to the 45-yard line. A first down for South Florida. Travis Bozeman tries to strip the football. Hugh Smith, his second major reception tonight, 28 yards on the game.
You know, this young guy was a running back last year, made the change to wide receiver. Crossing route right here, and I'll tell you what, his burst and explosiveness, a pretty good hit right there. Look at that, that's a great job. Up and down the field, makes another guy miss. Hang on to the football. Yes, sir, that's a big play.
Two catches, 57 yards for Hugh Smith. Remember, the Bulls lost their number one receiving weapon, DeAndre Ruben, to an ankle injury early in the game. First down at the 45. Movements by the South Florida Bulls on their offensive line.
That looked like Mike Snellgrove, the right tackle, got just a little bit over-anxious there. I think he's the only, he's from Dothan, Alabama. I think he's the only Alabama guy on their roster. And yeah, he's a little excited to be playing Troy State tonight.
Jim Leavitt was very impressed with the way he played, filling in for Ken Dawson at Baylor last week.
To the point where Ken Dawson's healthy and Mr. Snellgrove is still in there.
So far tonight, South Florida rolling over Troy State in yardage, 322 yards to 180. But the Bulls only lead by four. The fake, Raphael Williams. Nowhere to go. Jose Gamboa on the stop for Troy State.
Well, you know, the people might ask, you know, well, now why are they running that play? They're not getting anything done with it. You have to keep the pass rush of Troy State honest. You've got to run the little quick draws to the running back. You just can't let them tee off every snap. One of these times, that thing is going to pop for them.
Three wide receivers on the left side. South Florida with the four-point lead. 6:25 left to go in the third. Second and long, Blockwell. Going deep for McCready. Good coverage by Delrick Jackson, who had the interception a few moments ago. And Blackwell was leveled as soon as he let go of the football.
He really was. Take a look at it right here.
Man.
Well,
that
what.
Is a load, Shelton Felton. Yep. Shelton Felton, 6'2", 250 pounds, defensive lineman, a sophomore, all over Markwell Blackwell.
Don't ever think it doesn't take courage to play that position, boy. I tell you, your body's exposed. Here, take a look at the numbers on third down. Both teams about the same. South Florida a little better.
But this is third and 16. Blackwell steps up. Has Smith again. Fumbles, or they're calling it incomplete. Travis Bozeman, the big hit for Troy State. And it looked like Hugh Smith was going to come up with yet another big catch.
Yeah, he was right at the, that's pretty darn good for a young guy like that. He's right at the spot he needs to be. This is the first down. If he's able to hang on to this football, takes a pretty good shot right here. That's very, very well played defensively by Travis Bozeman.
Jim Leavitt has to be happy so far with the play of his football team. Number one in the country, Troy State. Sanderson, a booming punt. Reed takes it back to the 15. Called a fair catch. Barely.
Yeah, barely a fair catch signal. That really, honestly, could be interpreted as a penalty because you have to clearly get your hand above your head, and he did not do it.
Under 6 minutes left to go here in the third. South Florida, the four-point lead over number one Troy State. Otis Dixon's two-yard touchdown run, the difference, and the South Florida Bulls on a four-point lead over number one Troy State. Make plans to spend next Thursday evening with head coach Jim Leavitt at Winners Sports Grill in Wesley Chapel. Sports Radio 1010 The Team will be broadcasting the USF Bulls session with Jim Leavitt. The worst field position tonight for Troy State. Nutter looking deep, picked off by the Bulls. Anthony Henry. Markwell Blackwell gives up an interception, and Brock Nutter does exactly the same thing for Troy State.
The first play, and that was just great defense by South Florida. He wanted to throw in the flat. That was extremely well covered, and Henry really showed his athleticism. He actually was beat on that play, Al, and made a great, great recovery to get to the football. Watch this one. Watch him get up and intercept that ball at its greatest height. Wow, that's a fine, fine athlete right there.
And that's only the second interception on the season against Brock Nutter. And the Bulls now have their best field position here. Anthony Henry with the honors, and the Bulls have it at the 42. Raphael Williams. This rush defense, so very tough.
Yeah, they're tough up front, buddy. They are tough to run it against. But you know what? You have to keep pounding it. And Al, if South Florida can, a good football team now really takes advantage of this turnover. So this is really a key series right here.
By the way, Blackwell had gone 99 consecutive passes without an interception. That's the second longest streak in USF history. The record of 110 by Chad Barnhart. Second down and nine at the 41 after an interception by Anthony Henry. Bulls lead by four. Play action. Beautiful fake.
Got it.
McCready cuts back, has a first down.
Boy, Blackwell, I'm telling you, he is so smooth back there. The blitz comes scot-free, unblocked on him, and it's just like a man playing with a child. He can make people miss. And you just can't. Watch this. 92 is absolutely unblocked. Boy, he made him look foolish.
And I love the move by McCready. He knows exactly where the first down marker is, makes one move, and gets that first down.
That shows what a senior can do for you. This kid has been playing football. And young guys can't do that.
McCready, 5 catches, 58 yards, including a touchdown. And how about that? 240 yards passing and the touchdown by Markwell Blackwell from the 30. First and 10. Quick pass nearly picked off by Troy State and Jimmy McClain. Now, Jimmy McClain has a history against South Florida. He intercepted 2 passes last year against South Florida and took them back for touchdowns.
Yeah, he was the difference last year in that game. One was 80-something yards and another was 40 yards. Because South Florida had kind of shocked Troy State up there.
South Florida let a 21-7 lead slip away at a time when Troy State was rated number 3 in the country. 3 wide receivers at the top of your screen. Second down and 10.
Here's an audible.
5 seconds on the play clock. Blackwell, again, looking for McCready, incomplete.
Credit Troy State's defense right there. They got right up into the face of the wide receivers. They pressed the wide receivers. They totally took away the timing of the route. Anytime a DB gets his hands on that receiver at the line of scrimmage, the quarterback has no chance to time things up.
Bill Gramatica loosening up on the sidelines. He would be very close to his all-time USF record of 51 yards on a field goal try. He has the win behind him. Down and 10.
You need to get at least 5 or 6 yards here to give Gramatica a little better opportunity.
Blitz. Blackwell stands in, has Guerrero right in his hands. Guerrero cannot hold on. So here comes Gramatica. Nick Colbert in coverage for Troy State. And Gramatica on the season, 9 of 12 in the field goal department. Boy, is this a big one?
Huge, huge is the word.
This will be a 47-yard attempt. Again, wind at his back. He has a long of 51 yards. Last year, his long was 44 yards. But this is against the number one team in Division I AA. Good snap. Good hold, and the kick is just wide to the left. A missed opportunity for the South Florida Bulls that would have given them a 7-point advantage here late in the third period.
And the worst thing is now it really gives Troy State the football at about their own 30-yard line, and it really hurts your field position-wise, too.
South Florida had taken the lead at 14-10 and has really led the field position battle. Hit it good. It appears that he had plenty of distance, just misses it off to the left-hand side.
Yeah, from our angle, we couldn't tell exactly how far off it was, but it looked very, very close from here.
South Florida winning the yardage battle here in the second half. Carter, 5-yard gain on first down.
Yeah,
100 man's tackle.
100 yards to 5, and of course now it's 110. The South Florida defense has really just taken over in the second half now. And that's tough to do against this offense because I'll tell you what, hey, these boys are good. They can play.
But as we learned last year, they have so many big play players that they could come up with a big play from any place on the field and turn the game around.
Absolutely.
And here's the guy that can do it. Carter cuts back. Pulled down at the 48-yard line by Jay Mize, but Carter gets a first down.
Well, he's really strong. DeMontre Carter right there really showed his strength as a running back. And, of course, he's just a junior, but this guy's got a future, no question. Well, watch the strength here. Jay Mize, 197 pounds, and I guarantee he benches 400 pounds. Look at the strength right there. Wow.
Carter has gone over the 100-yard mark with that run. 23 yards here in the second half. Carter again. A big hole there, but maybe because of a hole. Yeah. Penalty flag down.
No question where that flag was thrown. Everybody in the world knows that's going to be a hold.
Penalties have hurt the South Florida Bulls, so on this drive, with Troy State late here in the third quarter trying to answer.
Holding on the offense. 10-yard penalty, spotted a foul, repeat, first down.
So this time it'll be Troy State in a hole.
Right here in the center of your screen, right there, looks like the hole to me. I can't quite see the number of the offensive player.
Four penalties for 22 yards. South Florida has four penalties for 45 yards. So the biggest penalty so far tonight for Troy State sets up first down and 19. Nutter was looking for his tight end, Adrian Moore.
Boy, and Sean Hay was all over Nutter that time, and I thought initially that was a poor throw, but he had Sean Hay breathing right down his neck.
Nutter beat this team a year ago with some big plays, and Nutter came in with 803 yards passing in three games, but the Bulls have been all over him tonight.
Yeah, they really have. That was great pressure by Sean Hay, and he came low on him, and that normally forces an overthrow, and it certainly did right there.
In this half, Nutter 2 of 7 for negative yardage. Beautiful tackle by Greg Walls. Greg Walls, his first tackle tonight. And this will set up third and long.
Well, another good series by the South Florida defense, and of course, really, let's be honest, so the key play in this series was the holding call, on the run with DeMontre Carter.
Jim Leavitt's defense so impressive tonight. They have held Troy State to 2 of 8 on third down. Third down and 19. Nearly picked off by the Bulls. Anthony Henry, J. Mize in the neighborhood. They nailed the wide receiver for Troy State, intended for Tommy Vennessey. Beautiful coverage by South Florida.
Yeah, that was a dangerous situation with Jay Mize and Anthony Henry colliding there. Looks like Anthony's okay. Let's take a look at the hit right here.
Whoa, man. That's a mark.
Woo.
Makes his mark on Brock Nutter.
Yeah, I guess.
Charlie Jackson standing at the 20, the fifth punt tonight for Troy State. Charlie Jackson calls for the fair catch at the 32, and the South Florida Bulls will have not so bad field position at the 32-yard line, a 31-yard punt by Matt Allen.
That was a fantastic job by Charlie Jackson of fielding that ball and not letting it bounce and roll down the field. You know, coaching punt returners my whole life, when the tip of the ball is down like that, I mean, that ball just dies right in front of you. That was a terrific job of him getting to that football. Watch it right here. I'm telling you now, this is not an easy play. See how the ball just died right in front? That's a great job by Charlie Jackson.
Matt Allen punting into the wind. 2:08 left to go in the third. From the shotgun, Markwell Blackwell takes off. So dangerous, 132 yards on the ground last week against Baylor, and he gets a first down at the 49-yard line.
I'll tell you what he did best right there is get out of bounds without taking a collision. You got the first down. Take a look at it right here now. Boys, you can just see the gap open up right there. Wow. Zone coverage.
Boy, Nazir Yamini simply got out of position.
Yeah. He's got great eyes. To me, that's really the strength of Markwell Blackwell. He sees the field. Look at this.
72 yards on the ground.
He's really starting to come into his own, Al.
Now has 312 yards rushing on the season. How about the quarterback draw now?
Oh!
Goes down at the 40-yard line, nearly busted another one, but it appears he has a first down.
Two first downs in a row by your quarterback. He's hot right there. He cut off the, outside foot and just lost his footing, because I'll tell you what, he had another 15 or 20.
They're going to measure for the first down. One more look.
Now, this is quarterback draw with a trap all the way. That was Snowgrove trapping right there, number 65. Watch right here.
Kenyatta Jones with a great block to spring it as well. First down, South Florida. 1:44 left to go in the third. South Florida, with his big play capability of Troy State, so desperate to put more points on the board. They own a four-point lead, but you know, with DeMontre Carter and Jonathan Carter and Brock Nutter, you're going to have to roll up some points. Last week, 368 yards of total offense. That a school record.
Wow.
And he's on his way to setting another school record.
Well, you know, they got the right guy because the quarterback is certainly featured in this offense.
240 yards passing, 82 yards on the ground. Blackwell after McCready again. Yep. Here comes a flag.
No question about it. Excellent call because he had a beat.
David Filia in coverage, and he's feeling blue.
And that was a good throw by Blackwell because without the interference, this is going to be a completion. You can't quite see it here, but there's all kinds of contact before the ball gets there. Yep, no question about that. Now, Al, it really becomes crucial because South Florida now in here in the second half, especially in the latter part of this quarter, they've been knocking on the door twice. They have to finish off a drive. They've got to finish off a drive, put points on the board.
Bill Gramatica missed a 47-yard field goal the last time the Bulls were in this territory. Penalties tonight, 5 for 37 for Troy State. South Florida with four. First and 10 from the 26-yard line. South Florida with a four-point lead. 1:47 left to go in the third. 2 seconds on the play clock, and the Bulls get it away. Blackwell over the head of Charlie Jackson. Travis Bozeman in coverage for Troy State.
That ball just sailed on him. I mean, that, you know, he set his feet good. He was in position to make a good throw, and that ball just kind of sailed and took off on him.
1:09 left to go in the third. South Florida on its opening drive of the second half marched 80 yards for the touchdown. Otis Dixon with the 2-yard run, but the big play was a 44-yard pass from Markwell Blackwell to Charlie Jackson. Blackwell so far tonight has missed 5 of his last 6 in the passing department. From the 26. Blackwell takes off again, already 82 yards on the ground, taken down at the 20-yard line. OC Umeniora with the honors and the tackle for Troy State.
You know, Al, you have to give this offensive staff a credit, Coach Canales, Calvin McGee, and all of them, because they really struggled offensively early in the season. And the last couple weeks now, they're really starting to come into their own. The key thing, I think, being they've really simplified their whole game plan. They've still got a young football team, giving these young guys a chance to kind of get their feet on the ground and get comfortable with things. There you see Chico Canales right there. Excellent. You know, sometimes as a coach, the most important trait you can have is patience when you're dealing with young players. You know, and you can't
very interesting.
Get overexcited.
It seems like the turnaround may have been at the Kentucky game. In the second half, they put together a two-play drive to drive some 80 yards for a touchdown. They put the ball in the end zone, and from that point forward, this football team has moved the football. So far tonight, Blackwell, 328 yards of total offense. Troy State, number one in the country, only with 194. Third down and 4 at the 20-yard line. Blackwell going to the end zone. McCready was there. Incomplete. Excellent coverage. Rayshon Reed.
Well, you called
it away.
You called it. I mean, you know, that was a good throw, and that was excellent coverage from Rayshon Reed. Take a look at it right here. I mean, he's really has him covered like a glove. Makes a nice play right there with his hand in on the football. Very, very good job. Young guy out of Phoenix City, Alabama. And boy, that city has produced a lot of great players down through the years.
Gramatica 0-for-1 tonight in the field goal department. He will now try a 37-yard attempt. He's missed a 47-yarder, and the kick is up and good. So the South Florida Bulls add to their lead. Excellent job by the holder. Petullo had trouble on the snap, gets it up in time, and Gramatica drills it.
Boy, these Gramatica guys can kick, can't they? And they tell me, Al, it's maybe the best one of all of them is the young guy by the name of Santiago Gramatica, who's a senior in high school. Look at this. Boy, that's got plenty of room to spare.
Again, an excellent job by Petullo to make all this possible. Had a little trouble on the snap, gets it down in time, and Gramatica drills it. 17-10. 20 seconds left to go in the third period. Troy State, the number one team in the country, undefeated, but has so many weapons offensively. They could come back, especially on a kick return, just like that. And I'm sure nobody knows that more than Jim Leavitt. And he's already instructing his special teams. Yep. But watch out for Carter.
Look out, he got both Carters back there.
Carter and Carter,
and I'll tell you what, I don't know. I mean, neither option is real good, Al. They're both good. Number two, of course, is Jonathan Carter. Number one is right there is DeMontre.
DeMontre came into this game with a 40-yard average on kick returns. A deep kick. Jonathan Carter pulls it out 5 yards deep. Gets a block from DeMontre Carter, and the Bulls are right there. Beautiful tackle by Salters. A 20-yard return. And again, Troy State pinned back deep in its own territory.
And that was also Julian Johnson
also in on the tackle. 1 minute, 48 seconds, 47 yards. Gramatica with the 37-yard field goal. And the Bulls take the lead at 17-10. 8 seconds left to go in the third. Brock Nutter has had a rough day.
You know, and Al, you can't take the coaching out of me. I keep watching number 74, Charles Thomas, the right offensive tackle. I think I can get a tip on run and pass off of his stance. This is run, I'm guessing.
Black busts his way to the 19-yard line. Roy Manns, how many times have we called his name tonight, the tackle for South Florida?
Yeah, I'll tell you, Manns, Jay Myers, Anthony Henry, they have been the key guys, no question about it.
The South Florida Bulls lead the number one team in the country, Division I AA. The South Florida Bulls, a 7-point advantage over the Trojans. 18-1 when leading heading into the fourth quarter. Again, South Florida 19-1 all time when leading heading into the fourth quarter. And tonight they are taking on the number one team in Division I AA. Oh, what an upset this would be for the South Florida Bulls. They are 2-4 against ranked teams in their last four games. Bouton hit hard. Four tacklers in the neighborhood leading
Jason
the way.
Butler.
Jason Butler, great story there.
Oh, yeah, I mean, that young man had a devastating knee injury last year. He's the first football player I've ever seen come back from that injury where you have nerve damage all the way down to your foot. And I just can't say enough about that young guy's courage and tenacity to come back from that injury. That's unbelievable to me.
You're talking a guy who was the defensive captain of this football team. Third down and 5, Troy State 2 of 9 on third down so far tonight. Nutter to the air. He was looking for Skipper. Incomplete.
Full blitz, good coverage by Henry. Forced a perfect throw, and they weren't able to make it.
As dangerous as Troy State is, and you keep waiting for that big play from Troy State, this defense of Jim Leavitt's in South Florida seems to be gaining confidence and momentum with every series.
Well, they really do. And this is one thing I think that's really helped this team. When you play the competition they've played, you know, Baylor, Kentucky, James Madison was a good football team, believe me. Competition makes you better, and that's what I'm seeing out here tonight. This team has improved.
Matt Allen, his sixth punt. This is a low punt. Charlie Jackson can take it on the bounce. Looking for some help. Cuts it up. He made all 5 yards on his own, believe me.
Yeah, he really did.
Taken down at the 40-yard line. And the Bulls, coming off a field goal from Bill Gramatica, will now have decent field position at the 40-yard line. 45-yard punt, 5-yard return.
Boy, that young man, I'll tell you, he has really been fun to watch the last couple of weeks. You and I have watched him grow up as a quarterback, and he's had some tough times, but he's hung in there real well, and now he really looks like he's ready to take off. No, there's never been a question as to his ability, never.
At the 40, first and 10, the Bulls just underway. Final period, they own a 7-point lead. Hugh Smith cuts it up, flag down. Jimmy McClain, the tackle.
Well, you know what, when you're in a one-back offense like this out of the shotgun, I mean, the runs that you can have, but let's face it, you're very limited. There's always a certain amount of things you can do.
Holding on that, South Florida.
Yeah, that looks, I would guess that's holding on the right offensive tackle. That would be Snellgrove, but I'm not positive, but that's where that flag was thrown.
Holding on the offense, 10 yards, previous spot. Run ended behind the line, repeat, first down.
Well, first and 20 now. Your odds, normally from a statistical standpoint, your odds of converting on first and 20 are about 10% of the time.
Five penalties, 55 yards. The Bulls basically played error-free football in the penalty department in the third quarter. They're burned by this here early in the fourth. Hugh Smith in motion. Blackwell in trouble and simply has to give it up. Runs out of bounds right around the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, they had a screen set up to the left-hand side. It was very well covered. He absolutely made the right decision. If you throw the ball and throw it away down the field, then you got a penalty for illegal, lineman downfield. That's the only option you have. Scramble, make something out of it. He did it.
And a very smart play for the sophomore. Again, another sign of maturity.
Absolutely. I've had a lot of quarterbacks, even as seniors, that couldn't make that play for you that would panic.
Blackwell now 89 yards on the ground and already closing in on 250 yards in the air. Last week, 368 yards of total offense, a school record. May have another one tonight. Finds his running back, Raphael Williams, at the 35. This will set up third down and very long. Yamini, the tackle for Troy State.
Troy State, now the last two snaps has played a real, real soft cover two. Difficult to throw the ball down the field. Take what's there, get positive yardage. Even if you have to punt it away, at least get positive yardage.
South Florida 3 of 8 on third down tonight.
This is the blitz look initially here by Troy State. Here it comes.
Blackwell hangs in, looking for his tight end, Guerrero, incomplete. Thompson coming in on the blitz, Antonio Thompson for Troy State.
Well, again, when you're first at 20 and you're looking at about a 10% opportunity to convert and get a first down there. So the big thing is don't make mistakes. Don't try to force the ball into coverage. That really was not a bad series by Blackwell. It really wasn't.
This will be the third punt tonight for Sanderson. Reed back to receive at his 35.
Oh, what a heck of a kick.
Reed going back inside his 20. And the Bulls are there in coverage. Vasse Mark, double duty. Big time plays on defense. Now he adds an even bigger play on special teams, and the Bulls lead by 7. 12:31 left to go in the contest. South Florida, a 7-point lead. By the way, tonight's student athlete profile brought to you by Dairy Farmers Got Milk. John Vigue, a senior right-handed pitcher from Seminole, Florida, majoring in business. Last year named the Conference USA Player of the Week, shutting down Houston, ranked number 9 in the country at the time. John Vigue, your Dairy Farmers Got Milk Student Athlete of the Week. Big series now for Troy State, the number 1 team in the country, Division 1 AA, from the 20-yard line. Nutter on the end around. Nobody home for the South Florida Bulls. Jay Mize and Anthony Williams pull it down for a 5-yard gain. It could have been much worse.
Oh, boy. I'll tell you, Jay Mize showed great discipline, stayed at home. Again, he was the backside force guy. And I'm talking about, now you're talking about a good athlete in the open field where you have to make an open tackle. Look at it right here. And real good help from Anthony Williams. Excellent recognition and recovery by Jay Mize right there. Beats the crap. That could have been called a clip if he'd made contact. Good defense by South Florida.
You keep waiting for that big play from
scary.
This potent offense of Troy State.
They're scary.
Wayne Thomas, his first carry tonight to the 30-yard line. Now Thomas, pulled down by Glenn Davis. He's a transfer from Alabama. Thomas killed the Bulls last year. Had about 5 carries for 80 yards.
Yep.
In that 41-24 win by Troy State. 153 yards on the ground now for Troy State.
They have transfers from all over the place. I think we counted 6 from Auburn. They have 1 from Alabama. They got 1 or 2 from Mississippi State, 1 from Southern Mississippi. Boy, they got a bunch of them.
This is close enough to measure. And it's short by about 6 inches.
Again, Lasix is definitely the winner.
Well, actually make it eight inches.
Okay.
8-9 inches. Sorry, Dr. Prada. I was looking away, and that's why I didn't exactly see. I knew there was an extra length there.
Yeah. Impressive. Well,
Jim Leavitt biting the nails.
Yeah,
for
he
good
really
reason. 12-11 left to go. His team leads by 7 points. By the way, 7 different players have carried the football today on rushing plays for Troy State. Third and short. Thomas, did he get there?
It's all on the spot.
May have been a fumble. Jason Butler jams things up. They're saying that Thomas lost the football after he was stopped. But is it enough for the first down?
Okay, Al. I'm really going to put some pressure on you here now.
I think this looks like a first down here if they measure this one.
You know what? I do, too. If I'm voting right here, I think I vote for first down. By 3 inches?
3-4 inches.
Yep. Uh-huh.
Again, make it 8.
Yep.
First down for the Trojans.
Well, here comes DeMontre Carter back in the game. Here comes Hayward Skipper back into the game. Here comes that other Carter guy back in the game, Jonathan Carter, number 2. Here's all the big play guys now.
11-25 and counting for the South Florida Bulls with their 7-point lead. Movement up front.
Looks like we may have a flag on the play.
Greg Walls got off to a quick start. Was he pulled off?
I didn't see any movement. I think this is on South Florida, unless somebody flinched.
And the Bulls are backing up.
Outside. Yep. On the defense. Contact made. 5 yards. Still first down.
You know, you just can't keep making these little, what might seem to be tiny mistakes, but now you give a team like this 1st and 5. You know, 90% of the time, they're going to convert this without any problem.
And not only convert it, but now you've given them a free play or two to come up with a big play.
Exactly.
At the 41, 1st and 5, DeMontre Carter in the backfield, and he's got the football. Leaps over the pile, gets a first down and more, fumbles the football. Sean Hay picks it up, and the Bulls, if they can keep this, get an incredible opportunity at the 42-yard line.
Boy, DeMontre Carter, you got to give him credit. He was fighting for extra yardage, and he took a heck of a shot. And out comes the ball, and that is the big play of the night for the South Florida defense. Great field position for the offense here. Let's take a look at it. Watch this, DeMontre Carter. Looked like Vase Mark got a hand in on the football. Heads up by Sean Hay. Put it away. Both hands on the ball.
Now the Bulls would love to wind down the clock here and also get some points on the board. Both are crucial. Blackwell says, I'll keep it. I'll put it into my own hands.
Look out.
I'll cut it to 30. I'll cut it back at the 25 and I'll get you a first down. Big game on first down for another first down after the turnover.
You want the ball in that young guy's hands.
Let's take a Zephyr Hills water break. So far tonight, only 45 yards of offense in the second half for Troy State. And the current total, 353 total yards for Blackwell. He's closing in on his record from a week ago. This water break has been brought to you by Zephyr Hills, natural spring water, pure water from a pure place. And right now, everything going pure for the South Florida Bulls. They're on the march at the 22 with the 7-point lead. Quarterback draw, Blackwell over the 20.
Well, you know, to me, the amazing thing about this performance by Blackwell, I mean, this is an outstanding defensive football team.
And a veteran off a defensive football team.
Exactly. This team is light years better than Baylor was last week defensively. I mean, their speed and that, Baylor was really not a very good defensive team. This is excellent game plan by Coach Canales, Calvin McGee, and that whole offensive staff.
244 yards in the air for Blackwell, 112 on the ground. Second down on the blitz. Blackwell nearly breaks it. Gorgeous tackle by Yamini.
Blackwell stopped for a loss. Back to the 25-yard line.
Jimmy McLean got free on the blitz, and again, Markwell did a good job getting that thing back almost to the line of scrimmage. Now, let the clock run. That's the key thing right here. If you don't get the first down, make sure that you got Gramatica in good position to give your team a 10-point lead.
If it stays here, it would probably be a 42-yard attempt. Blackwell, again, against the blitz, needs to get rid of it. There was a receiver in the neighborhood, and oh, how the Bulls did not want to take a sack in that situation.
Well, you know, if somehow South Florida can win this football game now, I mean, in my mind, this is their greatest victory in the fourth year of their program. This is a quality opponent.
It'll be their second victory over a team rated in the top 10 Division I AA, but this is number one. Gramatica, one of two tonight. This is a 42-yarder. Plenty of distance, and it's right down. Dale Mabry.
It's your
42 yards. The South Florida Bulls can smell an upset. The South Florida Bulls run their lead to 10 points. Remember, they're 19-1 when leading heading into the fourth quarter. They lead number one Troy State by 10. 13 unanswered points for the South Florida Bulls. A 5-play drive, 17 yards. Gramatica with the field goal, all set up because of the fumble recovery by Sean Hay. And Gramatica into the win. Nails it.
Sean Hayes had a big night tonight on defense. He's had a sack. He's had a lot of pressures and hurries. And then he comes up with a big fumble recovery. That senior's having a heck of a year for Jim Leavitt.
8:41 left to go. And I can guarantee you it will be the longest 8:41 of Jim Leavitt's life.
That's
nearly recovered by the Bulls. Oh! Nearly recovered by the Bulls. Troy State with the big mental error to allow that ball to go untouched.
Well, that was the pooch kick, and Troy State really went to sleep on that one.
Ron Hemingway nearly closed the door on Troy State. And in a way, now Troy State has its worst field position tonight. Keep an eye on number three.
I don't know what Jonathan Carter was thinking. Just let the ball go. Wow. Wow.
At the 6-yard line, Troy State, so much at stake. It's number one rating in Division I AA. And the Bulls Their fans are going to make some noise tonight. Nutter to the air. Nearly picked off by the Bulls. Kawika Mitchell knocks it away.
What a big hit by Jay Mize. South Florida, he's still down on the field, and Jay Mize is hurt too. That was a huge collision. South Florida was misaligned that time and actually trying to call a timeout. Watch this hit, folks.
Boom. Oh. Ooh. Jay Mize came up kind of having a stinger.
Yep.
Went in full force. He's had a neck injury. And that couldn't have helped him.
No, that couldn't help at all. And of course,
he may be about 2 inches shorter.
Got some definite numbness and tingling in that hand going all the way down to those fingers.
Nutter 2 of 10, no yards, and a pick in the second half. And now the crowd can sense a huge upset. 8:26, second down and 10 from the 8. Nutter stands in, tries to hit David Hill, but it was too low.
But now Joe Morgan is in the game at free safety, number 38. Now, that young guy has not had a lot of playing time. This is kind of a crucial situation for a young guy who hasn't played much.
I mean, you're only playing the number one team in the country.
Oh, yeah.
You're only in the fourth quarter. You're trying to preserve a 10-point lead. Kind of forces you to grow up in a hurry, I would imagine.
No, that was a delay of game on that. Of course, with the crowd noise, we certainly never heard the whistle, so now that makes it second. Brings it back to second down, and now half the distance.
Second down and very long. Second down and 13. 8 on the play clock. Nutter from his own end zone steps up. Troy State wanted a penalty.
Anthony
the Bulls
Williams.
Won a party. Well, Joe Morgan also in on coverage.
The Bulls are not too excited, are they, Al? Now this, hey guys, this is still third down, guys. They're leaving the field. I don't even think they know that was a delay of game on second down.
Third down and 13. Now neither team has converted a third down here in the second half. The Bulls would love to keep that streak in place right now. Troy State, 2 of 11 on third down. The biggest play of the game defensively for the Bulls right here. Nutter. Nearly picked off by Kenny Robinson. The receiver, Chad Lucas, cut it inside. And the pass went well over his head.
You know, the emotion of college football, watching that defense on the field, I'll tell you, those kids are having fun. They're pumped, they're jacked, and they're playing football the way it's supposed to be played.
Matt Allen will put his heels against the end line. South Florida with victories over number 6 Illinois State last year. James Madison this year, both top 10 teams. Can they add to that total against the number 1 team in the country? Allen gets it away. Very high punt. Great field position for the Bulls. Charlie Jackson at the 45. May try to lose ground. Lose a lot of ground if he can turn the corner. And he does. But still gives about 5 yards away. But if nothing else, he takes some time off the clock.
But there's a flag.
But there's a flag.
You know what? You just can't. You've got to have more discipline as a returner because you're almost always going to get a clip or a hold or something when you keep reversing field like that on a punt return. Boy, they had great field position. You just got to field the ball, make 3 or 4 yards, and get on the ground. That's all you got to do. That really hurts.
Honey Green,
It's probably about a 15-yard difference here with 7:55 left to go in the contest. South Florida, a 10-point lead over the number one team in the country. Can they hold on? 10-point lead, South Florida Bulls, 7:55 left to go, and it's time now for the Hops. Hit of the game, of course, is coming from the defense of the University of South Florida. Jay Mize, number 31, with the big leveling hit on Hayward Skipper. First down from the 40. The Bulls would love to work the clock. Otis Dixon gets it back to the line of scrimmage. Yamini, the stop for Troy State.
I like the philosophy right here. They're getting two tight ends in the game. Get your big back in the game and just try to hammer it here now. If you can get a first down here running the football, you know, the big thing is you really demoralize your opponent here if you can run it at him a little bit.
Three wide receivers split right side. Blackwell, 244 yards passing. One touchdown, one interception. 106 yards on the ground. That's 350 yards of total offense. Runs back the opposite way. Gets it over the 45-yard line, down to the 47. Good gain on second down. DeVern Williams, the stop for Troy State.
You know, Mark, well, Blackwell, he's a runner. I mean, you know, he is their offense right now. That's amazing. He's either going to run, he's going to throw it to the ball. You know, his durability and conditioning have got to be unbelievable, Al. I mean, you know, he's every single snap.
On the season now, Blackwell, 383 yards on the ground. He is now the number one rusher for the South Florida Bulls. And he calls timeout. Play clock winding down. 6:28 left to go in the contest. Doesn't take any chances. That's South Florida's first timeout. And again, going back to Blackwell, to have this performance after losing your number one receiver very early in the game to an ankle injury is even more impressive.
Well, it really is, because a lot of things in their game plan are designed to get DeAndre Rubin the ball. You know, you have to go to plan B when that happens, because DeAndre Rubin is so explosive, you have to do things to try to get him the ball. Now, just a little thing like that right there. The play on the previous play, the play clock was running down a month ago, and he may not see that to take a penalty right there. He called it with about 1 second left.
All right, we've got some time here. There's still 6:28 left to go, but when you look at the numbers of Markwell Blackwell, is he the player of the game? Could he be our Pepsi player of the game? Well, yes, he could. How about that? 356 yards of total offense. Are we putting the onus on him too soon, Coach?
If he's not the player of the game, Al, you and I need to be, you know, put in an institution or something. You know, I mean, he's clearly the player of the game here tonight.
I'll tell you what, if Jim Leavitt knows we've already named him the player of the game with 6:28 and counting, he'd be very nervous.
Well, it's not official yet, but he's definitely leading. Let's put it that way.
There we go. He's opened the Pepsi. Blackwell, all kinds of time. Charlie Jackson wide open at the 45. Cuts back. He's got a first down for the South Florida Bulls. He stays inbounds.
Exactly.
Although the clock still stops changing.
Yeah, on the
for the first down, but still an 11-yard gain.
The thought process was there. Now, if they could just get in the field goal range again and let Mr. Grammatica have another go at it, then I really, really like their chances.
South Florida, 13 unanswered points. And the clock is winding down, 6:05 and counting.
Here comes hammer time again, two tight ends. Got the dump truck in there at running back.
Two on the play clock.
Otis Dixon.
Otis Dixon pulls his way over the 40-yard line. Gain of 7 yards. Jimmy McClain finally comes in to make the stop for Troy Stiggs.
You know, Al, if you really think about it, this is absolutely incredible that this program in their fourth year of existence is doing this to the number one 1AA program in the country. And I'll guarantee you, Troy State is better than at least 50 of the Division I schools. I mean, no question about it.
Jim Leavitt said that Troy State, on film anyway, better than Baylor. maybe even better than Kentucky. Although next week, the South Florida Bulls will have their biggest game ever against number 22, Southern Miss. At the 38, Dixon again finds a hole left side. This may come back because of a flag. Oh, that's too bad. Yep. Travis Bozeman just hanging on for dear life on the tackle, but again, a flag at the line of scrimmage. 16 yards may go for nothing, and that could have gone a long ways into nailing the coffin for the number one team in the country.
Holding, on the offense, 10-yard penalty, spotted a fall, still
down. You know, the sad thing is that hold came nowhere's
away from the football.
Nowhere's near the point of attack. And as a coach, that is the most, you know, frustrating thing in the world to you.
Eight penalties, 80 yards. Now, to think you could commit eight penalties for 80 yards and still lead the number one team in the country by 10 points, it just makes you think about what you could have done.
Yeah, well, you know, the South Florida defense has always been capable of this, and the missing link was the offense, and now you got both going. And the special teams have always been great every single game this year.
Second and 16, the Bulls cannot afford a turnover here. That is the only way Troy State can get back into the football game. Blackwell, McCready, first down, South Florida at the 30.
Boy, what a big night by Scott McCready. I mean, this is a great, great fingertip grab. He reaches up. He knows he's going to get hit going over the middle. Terrific throw. Good protection. This is good offense, folks.
20-yard gain.
Five-step drop and let it go. A little bit high. Whoa, what a catch.
Blackwell. Has set a record. 385 yards of total offense.
Terrific. Unbelievable.
Couldn't have come at a better time.
The best thing is 419 and counting.
And a first down at the 30-yard line. Dixon spins back. Gain of 2 yards.
Notice Dixon on the ball.
This is a good job of coaching by this offensive staff. The reason for going to two tight ends out is now to stop the blitzing. I mean, they can't blitz from the corners and have a free run at the running back. Excellent job by Coach Canales. Get your big, strong back in the game that can hammer and pound. He's not a fumbler, of course, neither is Rafael Williams. But this is excellent strategy by South Florida.
3:32 and counting. 10-point lead. 13 unanswered points by the Bulls against the number one team in the country. Dixon again. He runs into Nick Colbert. Colbert takes him down behind the line of scrimmage, and this will set up third down and long.
Otis Dixon is not going to be a guy that's going to bounce the ball outside and make plays. He's got to keep pounding on the inside. He doesn't have enough speed to do that. Now, good job of coaching here by Troy State. They're not going to let that clock keep going. You're down to 3:17.
South Florida, 427 yards of offense against Troy State. 385 of those yards coming from Markwell Blackwell, that a school record. And the total yards for Troy State, only 219 yards. Now, Troy State coming in had held five of the last six opponents to less than 100 yards rushing. Blackwell already has 100 yards rushing all by himself.
Amazing. And now South Florida's got their receivers in, Al. They're going to spread the field here. Now, I'll guarantee you what Coach Leavitt is thinking right now. Okay, and this is a legitimate concern. If we don't get the first down here, are we going to kick a field goal?
The wind.
Well, the biggest concern is anytime you're kicking a field goal, you know, field goals can be blocked.
Absolutely. And it could come back the other way, and that would be a very quick way with 3:17 left to go for Troy State to get back into the contest.
Right. The one thing that makes you comfortable with kicking one is Gramatic. He gets the ball off so fast and high. I mean, this is a premier kicker.
From the 30, biggest play yet, South Florida. Third down and 10. The quarterback draw. Blackwell down to the 26-yard line. And another timeout.
Nice job by Troy State. That's a Coach Blakeney receiver. That's exactly what you want to start using your timeouts.
Fourth down and five. Gramatica just itching to run on the field. 2 for 3 tonight. He's got a 38-yarder. He's got a 42-yarder.
That's exactly what Jim Leavitt is thinking right now. He's trying to make this call, and here he goes on the field. And you know what? I agree. If you didn't have such a good snapper, holder, and kicker, you really have to think about it as a coach. But I like the call here. This Gramatica is just too good.
2 for 3 tonight.
He is attempting
11 of 14 on the season. This will be a 43-yard attempt. His longest tonight, of course, his longest on the season, 51 yards. He missed from 47 earlier tonight. The holder is Kevin Petullo. And it's wide right. So you take the chance. Either way, you have to be happy with the play of your defense at this point. Yes, Troy State will take over a decent field position.
Well, the key number here is they have one timeout left.
Now, and 3:05 remaining.
Right. Now, if you're Coach Blakeney, I mean, for Troy State, you go to your two-minute offense right now. That's really the only shot you have. And of some concern to South Florida is, you know, you've got your starting safety, Jay Mize, now out of the game, and you got a guy, Joe Morgan, who's played very, very little football back there.
The crowd on its feet. This crowd can sense an incredible upset. Nutter looking for his tight end, threw it behind him. Ironically, Joe Morgan in coverage.
Yep. And you know, Mark well.
Look at that. 90% of his offense tonight for the South Florida Bulls. 390 yards of total offense, 90%. I think now we can open that Pepsi, the joy of cola.
Should we make it official?
Jim Leavitt may open something else if he holds on. Nutter under pressure, and he's nailed.
Boy, the
Greg
clock,
Walls.
And the clock runs. That's the best thing about that sack. And there's their last timeout. I take my hat off to Troy State. They have done a beautiful job of controlling the clock in this situation. You absolutely have to take the timeout there with a sack.
Loss on the play. Third down and 11.
This is a very, very well-coached football team. That guy there has done a great job with that program. Now, I know he's certainly going to consider this a very, very bitter defeat, especially when you work and you work and you get yourself up to number one. And then, but South Florida, this program is very, very close to really arriving on the big-time college football scene.
Getting back to Blakeney, 41-18 coming into the game on the road.
Yeah.
Very impressive stat. I think the other thing that's impressive, coming into this game, there were 5-2 against Division I teams.
That's exactly right.
Nutter, 2 of 13, no yards and a pick here in the second half. He's missed his last 8. He's a guy that passed for more than 800 yards in 3 games coming into this contest. Had 4 touchdown passes against Alabama State his last time out. Third and long. Lays it out there for Black, and the Bulls are right there. Ron Johnson forced Black to turn it inside, and Joe Morgan comes up to finish him off.
Okay, fourth down.
Fourth down and 11, 2:26 and counting. Nutter the pump fake. Looking deep, coming back to the football. Chad Lucas, but it's incomplete. And the Bulls will have the football deep inside Troy State territory. No timeouts for Troy State. 2:11 left to go, and a 10-point lead.
That's the ball game now. They cannot stop the clock here. Now it's hammer time. Get those two tight ends out there again. Get Otis Dixon on the field. What a great, great win for South Florida. I mean, this is unbelievable, really. I honestly hate to say this, Al. I really did not think that they could beat this team today. That's how impressed I was with Troy State.
Job one, holding on to the football and letting the clock run. Dixon nailed at the line of scrimmage. May have lost a yard. Tim Betts, the transfer from South Carolina,
the tackle. The 25-yard line.
But the clock continues to run. Again, under 2 minutes.
Second down and 11.
Troy State cannot stop it. Blackwell close to 400 yards of total offense. This coming off a 368-yard performance at Baylor. Next week, another big one.
Yeah, incredible.
A step up to the top 25. A major college football traveling to Southern Miss.
Well, this football team has improved dramatically as this season has progressed.
Blackwell will keep it and just goes down. 122.
Blackwell keeps the ball.
Yep. Now they don't want to get too careless. There's still some time left. So far, look at that. The win over Jacksonville State, the win over James Madison, the losses at Kentucky, at Baylor. Coming up, the big trip to Southern Miss. Other Division I games left, UConn and Middle Tennessee State.
There's no question that the caliber of competition has helped this team improve dramatically this year as well.
Dixon nearly breaks it. Pulled down at the 20-yard line. Antonio Thompson with the stop for Troy State. 30 seconds left to go. And South Florida easily its biggest win in its four-year history.
No question about it. That's a great win.
And the South Florida Bulls will simply let the clock wind down. They'll soak this in. They're giving each other high fives. Jim Leavitt, when he came to South Florida, returning home, had dreams of building a program that could compete at the major college level. Another step tonight, knocking off the number one team in the country in Division I AA, Troy State, 20-10 the final. Lee Blakeney congratulating Rick Kravitz, ironically a Troy State grad, and they're the two head coaches shaking hands as South Florida pulls off its biggest win ever, 20-10 over number one Troy State. Jim Leavitt,
he looks a little wet, doesn't he?
Has already received his Gatorade shower. We'll come back to Tampa where they're celebrating at Raymond James Stadium. The South Florida Bulls go to 3-2 with the win over number one Troy State. University of South Florida football has been brought to you by Huntington, proud sponsor of the Junior Bulls Club. Hops Restaurant Bar and Brewery, it's all good. Dodge, in a perfect world, everything would be different. Dairy Farmers Incorporated, got milk? The Tampa Tribune, it's good to know. And by Pepsi, the joy of cola. South Florida now 20-1 when leading heading into the fourth quarter. South Florida 13 unanswered points. Remember, they trailed 10-7 at halftime. They come back to beat the number one team in the country, the Troy State Trojans. Nothing but hugs, nothing but a wet coach from the Gatorade and all kinds of handshakes as South Florida pulls off its biggest win yet.
Well, no question about that. And the key thing here, Ben, now you've got a football team playing that has been playing great defense all year. Now their offense is starting to crank, and they got great special teams. How far can this team go this year? We're going to find out next week.
How far will they go? They'll head to number 22, Southern Miss, in Hattiesburg next week. The South Florida Bulls beating number one Troy State. Jim Leavitt taking the vows, and for good reason, as the South Florida Bulls give him a shower as his Bulls upset number one Troy State, 20-10. For Doug Graber, I'm Al Keck. So long from Tampa.